The following is a special presentation of ESPN on ABC.
2 years ago, Adrian Peterson lit up the college football world, rushing for nearly 2,000 yards. He was second in the Heisman vote, the highest ever for a freshman. Despite battling ankle injuries last year, he still broke the 1,000-yard barrier. And in two games this season, the junior sensation is averaging over 150 yards a game. Peterson's the best running back in college football. Now he comes to Eugene to continue his high-stepping ways to the Heisman Trophy. But today, the Ducks of Oregon have other plans for these Oklahoma Sooners. The Sooners and the Ducks are on a collision course straight ahead. This year marks the 40th year that Autzen Stadium has been home of the Oregon Ducks. Built for just $2.5 million, a $90 million renovation a few years back has turned it into the jewel of the Pac-10. It is cozy, it is loud, and it is, as usual, sold out. It's Separation Saturday in college football as we begin to separate the pretenders from the contenders. Welcome to this top 20 battle between the Big 12's Oklahoma Sooners and the Pac-10's Oregon Ducks. Good afternoon, everybody. Dan Fouts. The Oregon Ducks are 2-0 on the season, having beaten Stanford and Fresno State. But this is a game they've waited 9 years for. A chance to avenge last year's Holiday Bowl loss to the Sooners. And a chance to see just how well their sophomore sensation, Jonathan Stewart, matches up against the great Adrian Peterson. And here comes Stewart and the Oregon Ducks. My partner is Tim Brandt. Tim, welcome as well. The Oregon Ducks desperately need to have a healthy and productive Jonathan Stewart today.
Well, so much of Oregon's game plan involves Jonathan Stewart, and he's been limited for 14 days now. Let's go back to that very first game. He ran for 168 yards against Stanford, but on this play right here, he landed awkwardly, got rolled up on, sprained his ankle. He's only carried the ball one time since. We just talked to Stewart earlier, and he said he's still not 100%, but he wants the ball 20 to 25 times today. If he's not in there, Jeremiah Johnson comes in. He's been stellar. Different kind of runner, good changeup guy. He's a dash and dart guy. He's averaging over 6 yards a carry. And Dennis Dixon, the quarterback, the trigger man, has not been sacked, has not thrown an interception. Today, he's got to be clean. He's got to get on the edge, and Oregon will have a good, solid chance here at home.
Well, for Oklahoma, they're also 2-0 on the season, and quarterback Paul Thompson has been very solid. But we're in for a real treat today, folks, to get to see Adrian Peterson run.
I think you agree. Adrian Peterson's the best running back in college football. He's big, he's strong, he's fast, he's got incredible instincts. They call him AD all day because he gets stronger as the game goes on. As a matter of fact, more than 60% of his career yards come in the second half. And when defenses load the box, then Paul Thompson, like last week, Washington loaded the box, Paul Thompson does play action, went 9 for 11 and a touchdown. Paul Thompson, if he doesn't hurt him today with turnovers, Oklahoma will be right in the thick of this thing late.
Well, the Sooners have never lost to the Ducks in 6 games, but this is Oklahoma's first visit to Autzen. Capacity's 54,000, but close to another 5,000 standing room only crazies hope to make this a day the Sooners will never forget. The kickoff is next. Back in Eugene, Oregon, the third member of our broadcast team is Jack Arute. And Jack, if it's not hard enough trying to stop Adrian Peterson, the Ducks have other problems, namely at that cornerback spot.
Yeah, we saw Walter Thurman. He's played very well as a redshirt freshman, but Jackie Bates went down with a broken leg 1 week ago. So who steps into the breach today? Another redshirt freshman, Jairus Byrd. Now, the problem with Jairus is he's never played corner before. Nick Aliotti's had a lot of sleepless nights concerning that, but he told both his corners today this will be their defining moment. Guys?
Well, Oklahoma has won the toss, but they will defer. Oregon will receive. Bob Stoops is in his eighth season leading the Sooners. What a job he's done. 77 wins, a national title, and return to prominence for Oklahoma football. And Mike Bellotti last week became the winningest coach in school history. Back in 2001, he led the Ducks to a number two ranking and a Fiesta Bowl win.
I think the most important stat there, you told me, he's only lost one non-conference opponent here at home during his tenure.
24-1 non-conference foes here in Autzen Stadium for Mike Bellotti. This is Garrett Hartley, back deep for Oregon. This will be Jonathan Stewart. Across the 20 to the 25-yard line, Jacob Gutierrez on the tackle for Oklahoma. Quarterbacking the Ducks will be junior Dennis Dixon. He's been cool and confident, and he is a dual threat. He's rushed for a touchdown and thrown for a touchdown in the first two games of the season. Stewart will open in the backfield for Oregon, number 28. The left side of Dixon. Ball marked at the 24-yard line for this first play. It's the option. No, Dixon's going to throw now. Almost intercepted. Zach Latimer had his hands on that one. Offensive lineup for the Ducks brought to you by City. And today, Tim, this offensive line of Oregon is going to be tested. They were embarrassed last year in that Holiday Bowl by the quickness of the front four of Oklahoma.
Yeah, the offensive line averages well over 300 pounds. You know, football's a game of angles and options and getting space. It's up to them to get Stewart space.
Second and 10. Four wide receivers fake to Stewart. Now the quick pass outside to Jason Williams. 40. 30. 20. Pushed out of bounds by Reggie Smith inside the 10-yard line.
Well, Dixon almost threw a pick on his first pass play, but then they come back and fake a little play action to Stewart, and they get the little slip screen out there to the wide receiver. Now just watch this. One step up, go back, get a blocker, catch the football, now turn it loose. He's got one guy to beat. Gets a block on him, and that's just enough to nudge him and get him into the open. It's a foot race. Huge game by Oregon, and that, folks, is a mindful, big confidence builder for Oregon.
Broke a tackle of Jason Carter, 67 yards on that completion. Bottom of the screen is Garen Strong taking Williams' spot here. First and goal for the Ducks. The hand inside to Stewart, breaks a tackle inside the five, down to the 2-yard line. Another broken tackle, this time Zach Latimer can't bring him down. Defensive lineups for the Sooners. And when you talk defense in Oklahoma, you talk about the great Rufus Alexander.
Well, he's a sideline to sideline guy. As a matter of fact, Alexander is to this defense what Peterson is to the Oklahoma offense. He's a big-time player. But the Oklahoma's already missed three tackles on this drive.
And that's something that's plagued them in their first two games against Alabama-Birmingham and last week against Washington. Alvin Thibodeau, the defensive end at the bottom of the screen, in for the Sooners. And inside Stewart, touchdown Oregon. Another broken tackle from 2 yards out. Jonathan Stewart, C.J. Ayu couldn't bring him down.
Yeah, and Stewart has yet to hit the ground. He has not gone to the ground yet. All the blocking goes this way, and he just comes up behind him and scores easily. Walks in. Zone blocking left. Be patient. Follow your read. Cut back against it. Nobody home.
Paul Martinez with the extra point. And the hold of Brady Leaf. He's perfect. The Ducks have scripted this one better. After near throwing a near interception on the first play of the game, they go four plays, 76 yards, in 1 minute, 21 seconds, and they lead the Oklahoma Sooners 7-0. You are watching ESPN College Football on ABC. Back in Eugene, Oregon, just underway in the first quarter. Oregon has struck first, but look out, Duck fans. This is number 28, Adrian Peterson, back deep on this kickoff. First attempt this year for Peterson as Matt Evenson of the Ducks will tee it up. 62 beautiful degrees here in Eugene today. Partly cloudy skies. Wind hardly any at 7 miles an hour. Peterson at the one. And he's corralled at about the 21. Good coverage by the Oregon special teams. John Pope with that tackle. Oklahoma quarterback is fifth-year senior Paul Thompson, making his fourth start at quarterback after playing some wide receiver last season. Perseverance should be his middle name.
And if you're Oklahoma, Dan, you can't panic. You took a shot to the mouth right out of the gates. They just have to go to their game plan now.
Joaquin Iglesias in motion. Thompson will throw on first down under pressure. He's got his man. That's fullback Ian Pleasant out of the backfield. Offensive lineups for the Sooners brought to you by City. And the Sooner receivers could have a productive day, especially in play action passing.
Well, because they're big. I mean, Kelly's 6'4", Iglesias is 6'2", and Joe John Finley 6'6". So, I mean, these are big guys that really get out in the open. We just saw his little safety valve on a play action there, and they pick up the first down.
Peterson is deep in the I formation on first and 10, and he gets it. First carry. He doesn't get much. Cole Linehan and Jeremy Gibbs at the bottom of that pile for the Oregon defense. And it's that defensive line that's going to be really tested today, trying to keep down Adrian Peterson.
That defensive coordinator, Nick Aliotti, really challenged him as well. This is a defensive line that last year had a gap filler with Haloti Ngata, but he's gone. And so the guys down on that defensive line, they've given up a lot of yardage to the run. Aliotti says, now today is your challenge. Let me see if you can slow down Adrian Peterson. And that's quite a tall order.
Two tight ends for the Sooners. Will John Finley in motion. Here's Peterson right side. And he's hit immediately as he crosses the line of scrimmage. Blair Phillips, the middle linebacker, leading tackler for the Ducks, brings him down.
No question, Peterson is a great running back. I think we both agree he's the best running back in college football. But I think the bottom line here is if they're going to put 8 and 9 guys in the box like they are, he's got to be able to break one-on-one tackles. He's got to be able to get to that second level.
Jairus Byrd, you saw it, number 32 coming up. Casey did break that first tackle. Byrd starting at corner for the first time. Willie Glasper is in now as Byrd moves to the nickel back on this third down and 6. Time running down and time has run out on the play clock, but they let it go anyway. Throwing deep and incomplete. Malcolm Kelly, the intended receiver, but the play clock had run down to 0, and the officials didn't notice it. Walter Thurman on the coverage as Paul Thompson's second pass sails incomplete.
I got to tell him, they gave him great protection, and Kelly was behind the defender. It was just overthrown.
Michael Cohen will punt for the Sooners. Back deep is Jeremiah Johnson. Johnson's brought back 6 punts this season for a healthy 15.5 yard average. Standing back at his 20 yard line. Almost blocked. Jameel Dowling almost blocked that. And the ball is shanked out of bounds. Rolls out at about the 27, 28 yard line. 36 yard punt by Michael Cohen. Jameel Dowling with the layout almost gets this punt from Cohen. You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC.
ESPN's College Football on ABC, brought to you by Nissan, proud presenter of the 2006 Heisman. Dr. Pepper, with 23 flavors in every Dr. Pepper, there's more to it. And Capital One, what's in your wallet?
Back at Autzen Stadium in Eugene, they've had plenty to yell about so far. Oregon getting on the board early, and their defense coming up big. 5 defensive backs will be employed by the Sooners on this set of downs. First and 10 from the 28-yard line for Dixon. Stewart next to him in the backfield. Straight back. Quick throw to Jordan Kent. And Kent's got a first down. Close to it. Rufus Alexander with the tackle. And Jack Arute, Jonathan Stewart has some help with some new footwear, huh?
Yeah, I feel like a Nike shoe salesman now. These are the normal Nikes that all the Ducks would wear. But what they've done now is they've taken this special Nike, flown in from Atlanta, Georgia. You notice it says Vic on it. They were designed for Mike Vic. They provide additional ankle immobility. They say that it could help Stewart go from, as Tim Brandt said, 97 to 98% today.
Well, it helped him pick up that first down right there. Running left. Remember, the sprained ankle is on the right side. But Stewart, with that carry, moves the chains.
And Oregon going with a hurry up, trying to really keep an up-tempo here so that there are no personnel groupings and no changes for that Oklahoma defense.
What a catch by Stewart. That ball was close to being a backwards pass. Zach Latimer with the coverage that time. Dangerous pass by Dennis Dixon.
Well, anybody that has seen Oregon play, they know they stretch you from sideline to sideline. They really create space and create a thin defense by spreading it out. This is a good play. Might have been a lateral, but he makes the catch and tries to get back to the line of scrimmage. Look how they spread you.
Yep, lost 1 yard, second and 11 now. Here's the inside pitch to Finley. That's not going anywhere. Well done by Stephen Coleman and Zach Latimer. The interior of that Oklahoma defense.
Well, they love this play. It's their version of a reverse, but it's a shuffle pass, so it would be incomplete if he dropped it. Watch this. All the action goes this way, and then, bam, come back the other way. And Finley is taken down immediately. This defense is very talented for Oklahoma, but got off to a slow start last week, got off to a slow start here today. So the coaches are trying to challenge him.
Loss of four on that play. From the 35 now, third and 15. Again, straight back over the middle. He's got his man. Brian Paysinger with a big catch. Longest catch of his young career at Oregon. Dixon with time to throw found Paysinger for 35 yards.
Vladimir screen, slot receiver, Paysinger. He comes in. Ball is thrown right into the middle of the zone. Perfectly thrown. They came with a blitz too. Playing some games up front. Almost got to Dixon. He stayed in there very, very comfortably and threw that pass perfectly.
And that was third and 15. Here's the option this time. Outside, it's Stewart. Diving down close to the 20-yard line. Dante Rosario with a clearing block on the perimeter. Nick Harris with the tackle, along with Jason Carter.
The Ducks have to feel very good about themselves right now. They're dominating the line of scrimmage. They've got the defense discombobulated a little bit. They're spreading them thin. They have to play one-on-one defense, and so far they haven't been able to do it.
Well, they have two bad plays to start this series, then bounce back on third and 15. And now a false start against Oregon. Rosario jumping from his tight end position.
Dead ball. False start.
Over 56% of their third down situation. That was a cool quarterback finding Paysinger over the middle.
And Bob Stoops is a cagey coach. He knows he can't fall behind 14-0 and be comfortable. He's on the road. He's in a hostile atmosphere. His team has been struggling a little bit on their heels.
And the thing that bothered him most is poor tackling, and we've seen plenty of that so far from the Sooners. Second and eight. Here's the hand to Stewart, left side, 25-yard line, and just powering his way, taking Sooners out of bounds.
Dan, the spread sets cause problems because they create one-on-one matchups. They limit the defense by formation. They create running lanes. They reduce blitzing, and they reduce the number of blocks needed up front. And if you've got a physical offensive line like Oregon has right now, boy, you're in business.
And they're setting their own tempo, their own pace, trying to wear down this athletic defense of the Sooners. Third and four now. Johnson, fake to him. Dixon's going to run. 20. 10 out of bounds. First down, Oregon. Pushed out of bounds by Reggie Smith. What a patient run for Dennis Dixon in traffic. 17 yards. Got away from C.J. Ayu.
Good play action. He looks downfield. He sees everybody covered. But more importantly, he sees a wide open middle of that field. And you mentioned the patience, just sitting behind blockers, picking up blockers, picking his way as he goes.
He's fast, but he also has game speed. As fast as he needs to.
Don't want to compare him to anybody, but he does remind you a little bit of Vince Young. You don't want to put him on that level, certainly, at this point in his career, but he does have those escape abilities.
Here's the option on first and goal. Bad pitch. Picked up by Stewart.
That's an
out of bounds.
Incomplete pass.
I was going to say that ball was pitched forward.
Therefore, it is incomplete.
I tell you what, this one may be challenged. It appears the design of this play was not to pitch this forward.
Well, so many of their plays are designed to be incomplete passes, but watch this one.
That may be a good call.
That's
it was
close.
So far out in front of Stewart. Here's a good look at it.
Even if they challenged it, I don't think there'd be indisputable video evidence to overturn that call.
Incomplete pass, so it'd be second and goal again from the 7-yard line. Three receivers to the top of the screen.
And there's your challenge.
Timeout. Oklahoma's called timeout.
First charged timeout.
So no challenge. I think they just want to regroup.
He 7:57 to go here in the first quarter. Oregon got on the board first thanks to a 67-yard pass and run, Stewart to Jason Williams, and then a 3-yard touchdown rush by Jonathan Stewart.
And when they say that Dennis Dixon is the best athlete Oregon has ever had at quarterback, does that upset you?
No, of course it doesn't. I've looked in the mirror plenty of times. But Mike Bellotti has had some really great quarterbacks
sure
in his
he
tenure here. And Joey Harrington and Keeley Smith, both fine athletes, but he says that Dixon is the finest athlete to
right.
play the quarterback position.
It's a heck of a compliment.
Let's check in with Matt Weiner back in New York. Matt, how you doing?
Dan, doing well. Let's get a Taco Bell update from Louisville. Miami took advantage of a roughing the kicker penalty, kept their drive alive. Tyrone Moss finishes it off with a 1-yard touchdown run. Meanwhile, BC wins in double overtime for the second straight week. The game ended on an incomplete pass, ruled an interception by review.
Finley and Stewart in the backfield with Dixon. Fake to Stewart. The pass now to Rosario inside the 5-yard line. Another misdirection play for Oregon. Nick Harris was not fooled, though.
Well, Rosario actually started on the left side of the formation. He's such a big guy, 6'4", 250. He just slid behind the line of scrimmage into the flats. Well-designed play.
He had Oregon's only touchdown last time these two teams played in the regular season.
See where he started? Behind the line of scrimmage, crosses over, gets into the flat. Almost impossible to stop that. That linebacker has to chase him, but he's in front of the line, the offensive line.
Third and goal now for Oregon. The quick throw, the alley-oop. And it's knocked away beautifully by Marcus Walker. Intended for Pasinger, but Walker just made a sensational play.
Well, he knows where he is in the end zone, and he knows where the out of bounds is, and he knows that the receiver's right behind him. He's only 5'11", so he's given up a lot of height to Pasinger, who's 6'2 and a half. But he did play it well, and he sure got it at its highest point.
Brady Leaf will hold for Paul Martinez from 21 yards out. Perfect. So two possessions for the Oregon Ducks, two scores. Oregon leads Oklahoma 10-0. You are watching ESPN College Football on ABC. Separation Saturday in college football with critical tests throughout the top 25 as we begin to separate the pretenders from the contenders. Scoring drive was highlighted by the third down and 15 pass to Pasinger from Dixon for 35 yards. And then Dixon with a fine run. This is Matt Evenson kicking off. And it's Adrian Peterson again. He's got a crease to the outside to the 30-yard line. Good return for Adrian Peterson. Jack, Bob Stoops had his team preparing kind of uniquely this way for the noise of Autzen, didn't he?
Yeah, Dan, most people will just pump in crowd noise, but what that does is creates headaches for the coaching staff. So what they did is they just took these little earpieces, stuck them in all the players' ears the first couple of days so that the coaches could talk at full decibel. They're not playing without it. They're playing without them today, but this crowd is loud.
And they'll get louder when the Ducks are on defense, that's for sure. Here's Peterson. Right side out to the 40-yard line.
I think some of those players would like to have those earplugs in when they're sitting on the bench because the coaches of Oklahoma are really getting after them, not happy with the way they've played.
Peterson just a little bit slow to get up. Jeremy Gibbs with a tackle. Gibbs, the junior college transfer from Stillwater. How about this man right here? Lights up a room with that smile.
You know, there's so much talk about a horse collar tackle that time. There's no question he was pulled down from the top. A legal tackle, but I mean, he just fell awkwardly. You talked about how slow he was getting up.
Well, he's at the top of the screen now as the Sooners go empty in the backfield. Thompson to throw. He's got Malcolm Kelly, and they've got a first down. They've yet to throw the ball to Peterson when he's either in the slot or out wide as he was that time. But as Stoop says, he is a threat without the ball as much sometimes as he is with it.
Well, while he's out there, he's got to go through and do what he's supposed to do. He missed a block, and that's exactly why they were able to make that play stop. Thurman just came up untouched. Peterson's got to get ahead on him.
Another timeout for the Sooners as Joe John Finley called the timeout.
Oklahoma second charged timeout.
Well, tonight a resurgent Nebraska team heads down to L.A. in search of an upset as they take on number 4 USC. Saturday night football presented by Southwest Airlines tonight, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC. College football lives here. Boy, the Trojans are tough at home. You're checking out Adrian Peterson's right leg now. This may be one of those cases where you get one of those burns from the artificial surface. Yeah, he's taking some skin off on that last run.
Yeah, look at that knee. Oh, that's ugly. Take another look at the spread formation when they went an empty backfield and they put him up top of the screen. Now watch number 28, top of your screen, and watch what happens at the end of this. This is his block, but pulls his leg along those numbers and on that artificial surface, ripped the skin right off his knee. We just talked about that yesterday, Dan, about when we were playing on this kind of stuff and the burns that you get.
Oh, the old days, it was like playing on a Brillo pad.
And you get those staph infections. Now they protect themselves pretty much.
This may have been where he got it.
All right, you see him pull him down by the collar, and look at his right knee there. He just went down awkwardly and slid on that knee.
Yeah, that skin will be scraped up and sold on eBay tomorrow. First and 10 for the Sooners now. Close to midfield. Peterson right up the middle, and he's got something. Broken tackle, first down. Adrian Peterson with his best run of the day. Broke the tackle of Patrick Chung.
Just exploded. Trap play, got good blocking, got into the second level.
14 yards of second level, Tim.
Boy, watch this. They block down this way. These guys come this way, and then he just comes and splits it right in the middle. Bam! Into the second level. Good tackle there to take him down, or he was gone.
Great block by Chris Messner, the senior left tackle, the dean of this offensive line. First and 10 now for the Sooners. Here comes the reverse. Iglesias got it. And he's stopped by Jairus Byrd. Heads up play by Jairus Byrd, playing his very first game as a cornerback. Has been a rover, the redshirt freshman, as a Jackie Bates injury had to be moved to corner.
Every time Oklahoma has gone to the empty backfield, it's gone to a completion. It's led to a completion all season long. Here that come to that formation. Now they run the reverse on the outside, but well defended by Oregon.
Ian Pleasant, the fullback, in front of Peterson on second and 8. Quick pass. Emmanuel Johnson with his first catch, and he's close to a first down. Bird pushes him out about 2 yards shy.
Johnson missed the opener with an ankle injury, and it's still bothering him. He's extremely fast, but after the catch, he could not cut up fast enough to stay in bounds.
Jeremy Gibbs hanging out in the Sooner huddle, and now he's going to get a penalty, probably for taunting or unsportsmanlike conduct.
That's a mental error. Why would he do that? That's crazy.
Well, he may think he's still back in Oklahoma. We told you he's from Stillwater. He's going to get a talking to now on the sidelines.
Dead ball foul on unsportsmanlike conduct on a defense. Half distance to the goal. First down.
You can take that stuff right back to Stillwater because that's a mental mistake. Emotion gets in the way of concentration. That is just a stupid penalty by Gibbs.
Lost his poise last week down in Fresno. Lucky not to get tossed out of that game. David Fahatete will come in and take his spot. The junior from Medford, Oregon, number 90. Oregon is thin at defensive line. They cannot afford to have Gibbs out too long.
Boy, if you're on that defense right now, you're eyeing 28, and you better get after him.
Iglesias in motion. First and 10, Sooners. Thompson. He's got Peterson out wide. We got a flag down, and Peterson goes down at about the 9-yard line. Patrick Chung with that tackle. Well, let's check out the penalty.
So instead of being inside the 10, the holding's going to take him back outside the red zone.
David Kataya is our referee for today. This is a Pac-10
holding
crew.
Offense, number 50. Penalty 10 yards, previous spot, repeat first down.
John Cooper, the sophomore from Fort Collins, Colorado. The great story is to have him in the lineup after breaking his ankle last year against Texas Tech. That's holding on, he's working against David Fahatete. So fresh legs come into the game, get a holding call in the center. First and 20. Iglesias again in motion. There's a handoff to Peterson right side, and he's not going to get much. Jarris Bird with another tackle. Here's Oregon's playing more zone now, Tim, to prevent Peterson from getting to the outside and using that great speed.
Well, they run that 4-2-5 defense, and it's really like the old days, and we talked about this earlier in the week, like the wide tackle six. You can get 7, 8, 9 guys in that box. Look at all these guys up here in green jerseys right here in the middle of the screen. And now all of them just chase down, inside out, gain leverage, complete leverage on the running back, Peterson.
And again, Peterson's going to spread all the way out to the numbers, the top of the screen. That's Adrian Peterson. And again, the Sooners have to call timeout, and they're out of timeouts
Oklahoma
in the first half.
Third and final timeout.
3 minutes and 22 seconds to go to in the first quarter. The Sooners are out of timeout. You are watching ESPN College Football on ABC. Back into it. Iglesias in motion. Snap to Thompson. A lot of time over the middle, incomplete. Trying to hit Iglesias over the middle. He went up with one hand but couldn't reel it in.
So Garrett Hartley comes on. His longest field goal this year is 44 yards. Longest of his career is 52. That was against Texas last year. But this will be into the wind. This ball's just a little bit high. Watch, he gets into the uncovered area in front of the safety and behind the linebacker. The ball was just thrown a little bit high.
McEachern will hold. Hartley will try one from 41 yards away. Good snap and a good kick.
Boy, that's a big kick for Oklahoma. Hurt themselves on the drive, but at least they're on the board. Now they're just 7 down, and that is big.
Well, apparently Brent Haberle, the linebacker for the Ducks, is a little nicked up. What's the story, Jack?
Yeah, well, they don't want to say what body part it is, but they've taken him to the locker room for an X-ray. And he left the game when the Oklahoma Sooners got into the red zone there. And Tuatelli, who had some good plays there during that drive, was the one that spelled him. So this defense continues to be nicked up, and I'm sure they're going to be looking forward to that off week next week.
Yeah, Mike Bellotti told him all about that off week. He says, I don't care if you're banged up or not. Lay it all on the line against Oklahoma, and you can rest next week.
Ducks played a very physical game against the Bulldogs of Fresno State last Saturday night, losing Jackie Bates. A number of players were hurting earlier in the week, but nothing like a Sooner Schooner coming to town to raise that level of adrenaline, get you back out there. This is Hartley to kick off. Deep for Oregon. Jeremiah Johnson. And he'll take it. A couple yards deep. Across the 20-yard line. And down there. Tackled by Curtis Lofton.
So far, Dennis Dixon has been almost flawless. He's got six completions, and there are six different receivers. Since the Ducks went to the spread attack last year, they added almost 10 points and 40 yards to their averages. And this year, that's even going up.
First and 10 for Oregon. Stewart in the backfield. Another quick throw. This is Jason Williams. First down, Oregon. Got inside of Jason Carter, and Dennis Dixon continues to roll.
Dennis Dixon out of the blocks in a hurry. I mean, he's throwing the ball with authority. He's reading perfectly. Get to the soft zone, hit it down the middle. He's buying time. And when he doesn't have time, watch this. How about this vision? Here's a guy that lets his eyes move his feet. And then the patience behind the blockers. Just a great game so far by Dixon.
Jonathan Stewart trying the left side of the Oregon offensive line. Corey Bennett, sophomore from San Antonio, with the tackle. Dixon 7 out of 10 so far. Talk about an offense fitting certain players' talents. This is it.
And how about this fast tempo they're setting? They're back at the line of scrimmage in a hurry.
This is tight end Ryan Keeling with the catch. He's close to a first down. Nick Harris with the tackle.
In the first year of running the spread attack, they never got to the point where they could maximize the tight end position. And it's become a point of emphasis. And they use Rosario and now Keeling, who's 6'5", and it brings up third and short.
Stewart, left side, first down and more. Into the secondary. Jason Carter has to come in and lay it down. Didn't need a whole big, very big hole. He got through it and into the secondary quickly behind Shergi and Lucas up front.
Boy, and just you talk about space, you talk about thinning the box. Watch the running lane right here. And then, folks, see you later. There he goes. He gets into the second level, and it's a one-on-one play.
16 yards that time. Dixon in trouble. He's going to go down. Calvin Thibodeau. And the fans don't like the way they twisted the body of Dixon down to the ground. Latimer, number 46, the leading tackler for the Sooners, like a broken play.
This defense right now needs some success, needs something good to happen, because Dixon's just picking them apart with his arm and his legs.
Now that is how the first quarter will end. Oregon strikes quickly, takes a 10-0 lead. The Sooners have come back with a Garrett Hartley field goal. Oregon leads this one 10-3 in Eugene. You are watching ESPN College Football on ABC. ...13 for Dixon. He's got and dropped. Brian Pasinger dropping that pass. Hey, time to check in now with Matt Weiner. Matt.
Dan, time for a singular All-America Player of the Week update. Drew Tate led the Hawkeyes who come back win over Iowa State, 274 yards passing, three touchdowns to claim the Cy Hawk Trophy. And Dan, to cast yours, you can text VOTE to 87654 on your singular wireless phone. Have a chance at a trip to the national title game.
Third and 13 for Dixon. He swings it out here to Stewart. He's got blockers in front, but he's not enough for a first down. Zach Latimer with another tackle with help from Nick Harris.
You know, Gary Croton, the offensive coordinator for Oregon, scripts the first 25 plays. He has been so successful. This is a bestseller, this script. He should stay with it. He now has seen how they react. He'll make his little subtle adjustments, especially for down and distances. But right now, Oregon just rolling. And this is the first stop we've seen of Oklahoma today.
Decision time for Bellotti. He's going to check out his field goal kicker, Paul Martinez, now. He's going to go way deep, too, for this one, Tim.
Yeah, this is
51 yards.
Out of his range, I thought.
Leaf to hold. Stemmer to snap. And you're right, Tim. Comes up about 10, 15 yards shy. And that will give Oklahoma great field position when we come back. 10-3 Ducks. You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC.
Anyway, that's the
It's Separation Saturday in college football as we begin to separate the pretenders from the contenders. And Tim, that was some decision by Bellotti. Could have pinned them deep in their own end with a punt.
A momentum changer. I mean, Paul Martinez, as long as his 51, he was trying to go. That's his longest, and that's what he tried and didn't even come close. You know, the thing about Martinez, Dan, he led the nation in field goals made per game last year, so Bellotti loves him and has a lot of confidence in him. But rather than pooching it down and get it inside the 10, you're giving Oregon now some room to run here. They score and tie this thing up. They get a little momentum. That's a momentum changer, that decision and that miss.
Peterson gains 4 on first down. Again, good field position for Oklahoma as they near the 40-yard line. Finley in motion. Fake to Peterson. Deep drop, and there's pressure, and down he goes. Walter Thurman, like a bullet, brings down the quarterback. First sack of his career, the redshirt freshman with a big play. 10 yards on the loss.
Dan, you want to look at this from the coach's view. I mean, you're playing with redshirt freshmen, but watch how they come clean. Thurman getting his start, redshirt freshman, never got blocked, had a clean alley, broke down and made the tackle.
Yeah, but he's hurt. Walter Thurman has a sore right shoulder. Peterson top of the screen. Here's the screen to the bottom of the television screen. It's not going anywhere to Fred Strong. Blair Phillips, middle linebacker, read that one.
Phillips has been one of the leading tacklers all season, and what they're doing is they're wrapping up and they're not letting go. They're grabbing cloth. Terrific tacklers, and that's something that they've worked on hard here at Oregon. The Ducks now are wrapping, and one guy is making the tackle and waiting for pursuit to come.
Michael Cohen to punt. Jeremiah Johnson deep for the Ducks. Low snap. Cohen gets it off, and
wow.
It's a beauty. Pushing Johnson back inside his 20. And he gets it out to the 31-yard line. Fine return by Jeremiah Johnson, who continues to excel on special teams. 53-yard punt by Cohen. Johnson brings it back 14. You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC.
ESPN's College Football on ABC, brought to you by the totally new Jeep Compass, freedom in a whole new dimension. Under Armour, the advantage is undeniable. IBM, what makes you special? And Midas, for mechanics known for their work and their word. Trust the Midas touch.
Back in Eugene, the Ducks will start at the 32-yard line. Best starting field position for them. This their fourth possession of the first half. Stewart in the backfield, fake to him. Dixon to throw. He's going to throw deep for Jordan Kent. Kent goes up and he can't bring it in. Marcus Walker at 5'11", trying to defend the 6'5 basketball player, Jordan Kent, and Kent couldn't bring it in with one hand.
Well, I tell you what, though, Dixon is putting that where his guys can get it. That's a, people look at this and say dangerous pass, but he knows that he's got the height advantage, and he knows Kent has that big vertical leap. Put it up there, and that was almost a completion. Walker, as you mentioned, 5'11", guy with two shoulder surgeries reaching up like that, no chance.
Heck of a play by Walker. Second and 10 now from the 32. We got flags. Anoka Lucas, the center. And he had problems in the Holiday Bowl last year with a number of low snaps.
Dead ball, false start. On the offense, the line. 5 yards, second down.
Lucas, captain of the offense, the anchor of that offensive line.
Jack, what's the latest on Walter Thurman, the third?
Well, they've said that he's got a shoulder stinger, so they're going to sit him out for a while. Also out right now is Cameron Colvin, the wide receiver. They were icing down his hamstring. Guys.
Never good news for a receiver. No, icing they're getting down the hamstring.
And they're getting thin at receiver.
After the penalty, second and 15, the blitz, and Dixon gets it away, and it's almost intercepted by Reggie Smith. Latimer came right up the middle and forced that errant throw by Dennis Dixon.
Boy, what a great play by Smith, though. Just hung on the hip pocket, played him inside out, and just knocked it away. Can't play defense any better than that. Watch the end of this. Dixon locked on. His head's looking at him all the way. Really didn't have that much pressure. He was just trying to throw it quicker and had to hold on longer than he wanted to. Didn't throw it on time.
I think when Rufus Alexander's coming at you, that speeds up the clock a little bit.
But keep in mind, he hasn't been sacked all year.
Third and 15 now. Again, over the middle, incomplete. Trying to squeeze it in to Jason Williams.
And again, Smith comes in with that one hand and just rakes it out of there. Riding his hip pocket, reading it all the way, and timing it perfectly.
The Ducks are attacking the Sooners' best cornerback in Reggie Smith. Dixon, though, not only has he not been sacked this year, Tim, 145 throws, he's yet to throw an interception. That's going back to last year.
Look at number three, playing it perfectly. The left hand is off, the right hand goes and slaps it away. Former safety, now corner.
Matt Dragich will punt to Reggie Smith. Averaging 40 yards a punt with a long of 51. Tail dragger, short punt. Good bounce for Oregon, and out of bounds and away from Reggie Smith.
But good field position for the Sooners.
Forty-yard punt for Dragich, no return. Sooners have the ball when we come back. Back in Eugene, Oregon, where the Ducks lead the Sooners 10-3. Good field position to start this drive for Paul Thompson. Back in the game for the Ducks, number 99, Jeremy Gibbs, and Walter Thurman at corner. Adrian Peterson deep in the I formation. He gets it right up the middle. And he gets just a couple.
You know, when you watch him run, he just seems to be getting better as the game goes on. He's getting off his stance quicker. He's getting to the hole quicker. He's putting his head down. He's getting tougher. Just have a feeling he's going to explode.
He's a guy that you hold your breath every time he is handed the ball.
He only has 7 carries for 35 yards, but you just have that feeling, Dan, that he's just going to take one to the house.
3 wide receivers, Iglesias in motion. Peterson gets it left side this time, and Cole Linehan, the sophomore from Forest Grove, Oregon, and Banks High School with that tackle.
Linebackers reading, watching him, keying on him. Watch this. These guys, their eyes are on number 28. Here's the handoff. Read, scrape, get outside. Boy, Linehan, really nicely done.
As if they have to prompt this crowd to make noise on a 3rd down and 8. Thompson changing the play. Over the middle, incomplete to Malcolm Kelly. He thought he had single coverage on the outside, but Ryan DiPaolo came from his safety spot to double-team Malcolm Kelly. Jack, what's the latest?
Well, when you watch that series, you see the way the 28 for the Sooners has been shut down. Adrian Peterson is the linchpin to this offense. Nick Eliotti told his defense that and said, if we can shut down Peterson and make Paul Thompson win or lose this game, we've got a shot. So far, so good, guys.
Derek Shaw to snap to Michael Cohen. Had a dribbler last time he snapped one. Good snap this time, and another good punt by Cohen. Away from Jeremiah Johnson. And it rolls dead at about the 22-yard line. Now let's check in with Matt Weiner with a SportsCenter in-game.
All right, Dan, Penn State humbled last week in South Bend. Just scored to go up 10-0 on 1AA Youngstown State. Meanwhile, Michigan flourishing at Notre Dame, up 20-7. Mike Hart has scored following a Darius Walker fumble. Michigan has scored 14 points off two Irish turnovers.
Brady Leaf at quarterback, and it's on the ground.
And we got a flag thrown in there, maybe a face mask here, but Leaf's first play, he cannot connect on the shotgun snap.
Incidental face mask on the defense. 5 yards to the previous spot. Repeat first down.
What a break that is for Oregon.
Yeah, Brady Leaf comes in. He's reading the defense. He's not even looking at the snap. Just watch his head. He's looking to the left at the motion. Snap comes, and that is a huge break by the face mask call against Oklahoma. Instead of a 5-yard loss, second and 15, it's first down and 5.
I think they got Nick Harris that time. Wasn't much of a face mask. Here's the inside handoff. And Finley is tackled there by Nick Harris. Harris at 6'3", 230 pounds of strong safety. Big play there.
Nothing wrong with Dixon. They just like to get Brady Leaf in and get him some snaps, get him some repetitions.
And a rough handoff to Jonathan Stewart there.
Yeah, and the crowd wants Dixon back in right now. They aren't happy because it's taken away their momentum.
Dixon on the sidelines. Looking a little bit like Captain Jack Sparrow there.
This is something Gary Groten, the offensive coordinator, said he wanted to do. Brady Leaf has earned some playing time, and so they like to reel him in now every once in a while, but it is taking away their momentum.
Well, on third and 9, he throws it outside to Jordan Kent, and Jordan Kent's not going to get anything.
Listen,
Jason Carter with that tackle. And these boos aren't necessarily directed at Leaf. They're directed at the coaching staff.
Oh, absolutely.
For making this decision. Dixon has been performing flawlessly, not only today, but all year. So Dragic comes out for Oregon to punt back to Oklahoma, and the Sooners should get great field position. Reggie Smith deep at about the 41, 42-yard line. And we've got a flag before that ball was punted. It appeared that Nick Reed may have moved early, backing out of his stance.
You know, nothing against Brady Leaf because he really has worked hard.
Dead ball, false start, left side of the offensive line.
But this is just getting worse.
See,
this is getting worse now. They're moving it back. Now, Oklahoma's going to have great field position here. The momentum has changed with 7.5 to play in the first half.
No question that momentum, thanks to the play of Oregon, this last couple of plays has swung over to the side of the Sooners. Eric Steimer will snap this one. And a better punt this time by Dragic. Fair catch called for and made by Reggie Smith.
Dan, let's take a look at the Pacific Life game summary. We'll tell you how this game got going early. Oregon with a 10-0 lead, mainly because of Dennis Dixon. He played so well early on, just reading the defense, maintaining his composure, passing 9 for 16, 138 yards. This was the big play early. And then when he dropped back to pass, he saw the middle open up. He's got 2 carries for 14 yards. That's been the difference. And Jonathan Stewart, not as many carries as we thought early, but he's got 7 for 42. Adrian Peterson, where is he? AD has not really shown up yet. He's got 8 carries, 33 yards, no touchdowns. They've held him in check.
Flag down. Thompson throwing deep. He's got a man behind the secondary. Joaquin Iglesias walks into the end zone. Touchdown Sooners.
And the way the Oklahoma coaches are reacting, this flag is going to be against the Sooners.
...58-yard bomb. And it's coming back. Penalties continue to haunt Stoops' team.
Illegal formation offense. Five-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Five-yard break.
Iglesias got behind Jairus Byrd. He was wide open. Thompson saw him, but it was an illegal formation.
Unbelievable. This has been a nightmare of a first half for Oklahoma.
Malcolm Kelly goes to the top of the screen. Iglesias in the slot. Now in motion. Fred Strong at the bottom of the screen. Here's the hand to Peterson. And he gets pushed out of bounds by the other number 28, the forgotten 28. That's J.D. Nelson.
You know, everybody talks about loading the box to stop Peterson, but they also have great containment. And they're running to the football. Great pursuit. Watch this. These guys have the outside, so they know that if he gets outside, look at the break on the ball. Just run him out of bounds. They're cutting off angles. They're cutting off his options. And everybody's running to Peterson.
Second and 11 from the 41. Again, the fake to Peterson, the throw outside. And Malcolm Kelly can't bring it in. Jairus Byrd knocked it away.
So far, Nick Aliotti's defensive game plan is working to perfection. Stop Peterson, stop the big plays, and let Paul Thompson beat us if he can. Again, they put 8 guys in the box, loaded up for the run. Thompson goes to the pass. He's got a little bit of backside pressure, steps up and throws it high.
Darius Sanders with that pressure. Sooners are 0 for 4 converting third downs in this first half. This is a tough one at third and 11. Iglesias moves. Fake to Peterson. Throw down the sidelines for Kelly. Thrown too far. Coverage by Walter Thurman. And Thurman cut off Kelly. Couldn't get to that long throw. 0 for 5 now on third downs for the Sooners.
Well, the theory for the Sooners is good. Pass to get them out of the box so we can free up Peterson. But unless you hit these, and there's the contact playing inside out, that is great defense. That's not interference. Great defense inside out using the sidelines. Unless he completes some of those passes, Dan, they're going to keep the box loaded.
No question about that, Tim. Cohen for another punt and another beauty. Really high. Fair catch ball by Johnson. Drops it. Ball bounced forward. It went under a Sooner, and now the Sooners have got it at the 20-yard line.
That's their biggest play of the game.
Jeremiah Johnson with his second fumble on a punt return this year. Recovery by Hayes. Lewis Baker, the linebacker on special teams. James Finley appears to have a bad shoulder as he goes to the sidelines. He was one of the first Ducks to try to recover this one.
Went right through his arms. Looked up, had it locked, called the fair catch. Didn't get his body under the ball, reached out. Watch this. Here's the fair catch, comes up, never gets his body there. Goes right through his arms, and that ball's loose, and the Sooners get it.
First and 10 at the Duck 20. Peterson right up the middle. And he runs right into A.J. Tuitelli.
Tuatelli in the game for an injured Brent Haverly. Making another fine play.
Cohen's punt was like a knuckleball, too. That thing was moving. Tough catch.
3 yards on the gain for Peterson. Kelly goes wide to the top of the screen. Iglesias now will go in motion. Fake to Peterson. Thompson's got room. He throws. He's got Iglesias inside the 10. Kwame Ajerman and J.D. Nelson on the tackle, but this is going to be first and goal for the Sooners. Best throw of the game for Paul Thompson.
Absolutely. And he did it on the roll, Dan. He threw it across his body and he put something on it, too. That baby was a tight spiral with zip. That's the inside receiver, number 9. That's Iglesias. He'll go down. Bam. Sits down. The ball's waiting for him. Threw the ball before he even turned for it.
High formation now for the Sooners. Finley in motion. Peterson deep. And he gets it. And again, trying to middle of that Oregon line, J.D. Nelson, one of many duck tacklers on the play.
Tell you what, if Thompson can hit a few more of those passes like he did to Iglesias, he'll get out of that box. That's what he did last week in the second half. Went 9 for 11, 170 yards and a touchdown. That got him out of the box, and then Peterson exploded.
Second and goal now. Finley shifts to the weak side. Fake to Peterson. Over the middle, thrown too high. Flag down.
Half the distance.
Walter Thurman hanging all over Malcolm Kelly draws the flag.
Pass interference defense. Number 28. Ball will be placed at the 2-yard line as the foul occurred in the end zone. Automatic first down.
Gonna get J.D. Nelson. The Oregon fans are saying this ball was thrown too high, not catchable.
Yeah, but look at the safety in the corner. They say, I'll meet you half the distance right between each other. They funnel him in there, but there's contact while the ball's in the air. So they move it right down to the 2.
J.D. Nelson wasn't anywhere near that play. So it'll be first and goal at the 2-yard line. Peterson. No, nothing. Blair Phillips first to meet him with Cole Linehan.
Not only met him, he stoned him.
You don't see Adrian Peterson going backwards very often.
Phillips is 6'2", 240 pounds. He's a senior. Met him right up in the line of scrimmage. Tuck that tail, sky the eyes, and drive. Watch this. Into the hole, meet the linebacker. Here he is. Stand him up, get help, and move him back.
Second and goal. We got a false start here. Flags have come flying. And you can hand this one and give credit to the Oregon crowd. Brody Eldridge, the redshirt freshman, rather, moved early. And this was what really killed Oklahoma last week against Washington when they had 5 of these false starts.
Dead ball. False start. Offense. Number 83. 5 yards. We'll check it out.
You know, Tim, after that play, Adrian Peterson appeared to be a little bit upset with banging his head against that Oregon defense. I would think that he wants that ball on the perimeter and quit testing the middle of that Oregon defense.
Yeah, he's definitely frustrated, no question about it. But I would go to a play action right here. And Thompson, it's up to Thompson now because they've been just stopping Peterson.
Thompson in the shotgun. Iglesias moves across the formation. Ducks are looking like blitz. And we got another false start. Chris Messner this time. The senior left tackle moved early. Again, the Autzen crowd making a difference. And the players appreciating it.
Offense, number 79. 5 yards, second down.
Dan, that cannot happen. Messner's a senior. He's the lone returning starter from last year. Moved from right tackle to left tackle. And he just jumped, got anxious. As you say, the crowd affected him.
Yeah, and also the Oregon linebackers jumping up into the line may have caught his eye as well. So the Sooners are going backwards now. It's still second down and goal. 3 minutes to go here in the first half. Thompson in trouble. Another flag down. Thompson's got some room now. 10-5 out of bounds. They may get Chris Messner one more time, this time for holding.
This is unbelievable. Bob Stoops can't believe it.
Messner holding on Matt Tuena.
Holding. Offense. Number 79. 10-yard penalty. Still second down.
Messner again. Here he is right here. Almost a tackle.
That's why Thompson bobbled that ball. Tuena got a hand on it.
And negates another huge play.
Three consecutive penalties after being on the 2-yard line at second and goal. Finley in motion. Peterson wide to the right side. And he's bouncing off tacklers before Chung can bring him down.
He's unbelievable.
Determination.
He's an incredible runner. He does so much of it with his strength. He's got that low center of gravity despite the fact that he's 6'2", 218. Big, powerful guy.
You know, I love talking to Paul Thompson yesterday. I asked him his impressions of number 28. First word, dependability.
He's solid and never gives the tackler his full body.
And his second thought was he's going to make at least one huge play a game. Third and goal from the 13. Thompson to throw for it. He's got Finley. No, Brody Eldridge. And Eldridge is knocked out of bounds, short of the goal line.
Well, you know, if you're a defensive back and you see Eldridge coming at you, 6'5", 250 pounds with momentum, that's not an assignment you really like.
Leading tackler for the Ducks coming into today, Patrick Chung, gets Eldridge out of bounds here.
All right, Eldridge turns it up now and lowers that shoulder. Still really nice play just to get him out of bounds.
Chung gives up 45 pounds. This will bring out Garrett Hartley for the field goal try. Going to mark this one just inside the 11. So this will be a 20-yard field goal attempt. And he's got it. So after being first and goal at the 2-yard line, penalties push the Sooners back. But Bob Stoops is happy he's got 3 points out of it. 10-6 is our score with 2:01 to go in the first half. You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC. To go in the first half. We realize we're having some video problems. We apologize for those. We're working on it. Don't want you to miss any of this one. This one's got the feeling of a last second play to win this one. Here's Hartley to kick off. And deep for Oregon. This is a good kickoff. Jeremiah Johnson. Barely out to the 20-yard line. Let's check in now with Matt Weiner with a SportsCenter in-game.
All right, Dan, a little bit of a nervous start for Louisville at home against Miami, but Brian Brohm to Mario Urrutia, and the big man gets behind the Cane defense and goes 56 yards. Braun already 168 yards passing now at halftime, and the Cardinals lead at 10-7. All Michigan 27-7 in South Bend.
Thank you, Matt. Ducks will start at the 20-yard line. Less than 2 minutes to go in the first half. Dixon hit from behind. That's a fumble. Larry Burdine with the pressure. Oregon with the recovery.
That's the first time somebody's gotten to Dixon this season.
Yep, first sack. Could have been disastrous for the men in green.
Now we'll see how Dixon reacts. It doesn't seem to have bothered him, but this is backside. He couldn't feel it. Steps up. Bam. Good call. No incompletion, just a fumble.
That's the first sack for the Sooners all year. Inside handoff to Gallup. Stewart 25-yard line, knocked out of bounds by Darian Williams. Now it's time for this week's Aflac trivia question. Which team is the only non-conference team to defeat Oregon at home under Mike Bellotti?
It's a good question.
And it's proper English.
I would expect nothing else from you.
Good gain on that second down by Stewart. Brings up a manageable third down and four. Oregon has all three timeouts remaining. Dixon, completion to Rosario. First down, Oregon.
Well, what a big-time catch by Rosario, too. The ball was almost deflected. Rosario had that broken right hand during the preseason. It said it helped him work on one-handed catches. He almost caught this thing one-handed. It looked like he had a bear paw out there.
Clock rolls. First and 10. Fake to Stewart. Dixon looking around, looking deep. Too far for Jordan Kent. Kent got behind the secondary and Reggie Smith. Ball about 2 yards too far. Well, earlier we asked you the Aflac trivia question, which is the only non-conference team to defeat Oregon at home under Mike Bellotti? The answer is Indiana, 30-24. That was the start of the season that was a dismal season here in Eugene as the Ducks finished 5-6.
Yeah, and they had those high hopes. I mean, they were loaded with potential, much like this team. But as you said, finished 5-6. Bellotti's only losing season in his 11 years.
Stewart's got it. Big hole. Midfield. Sooner territory. Jason Carter with the tackle. Jonathan Stewart having a monster first half against the Sooners.
Well, he says he's got a lot to prove. Here he is. And then you just watch him just kind of explode, but he gets great blocking up front. Sees the hole, dances through it. Now he's in the second level, explodes. And keep in mind, he's 234 pounds. So not only is he fast, but he's also very powerful. He's shorter than Peterson, but wears the same number and possesses a lot of the same talents.
And one of the Oregon offensive linemen, as the Ducks have called timeout, Polani Massoon, who had a tough time in last year's game against the quickness of the Sooner defensive line, and Dusty Dvorak. Well, he dropped 40 pounds in the offseason. He's down to 330. That's dropping. He had a key block on that play. Well, Monday night on ESPN continues as Joey Porter and a strong Steelers defense lead the defending Super Bowl champs against Byron Leftwich and the Jaguars. Is it Monday yet? Monday Night Football on ESPN, Monday at 8:30 Eastern. Also available in high definition on ESPN HD. Call your cable operator or satellite provider right now.
Talking about the 228s, and certainly we came into this ballgame looking at Peterson and Stewart, and this is what's happened so far today. Right now, Jonathan Stewart with the advantage, and look at the average. 7 yards, and of course, he's got that early touchdown.
Dixon, quick throw to the outside, and Kent's on a knee, and he goes down. So the clock will roll. Mistake by Kent to go down on his knees to catch this ball. And the Ducks will have to use another timeout.
Well, his first responsibility is to make that catch. I think he felt the only way he could is to get down low with it.
Well, he is 6'5".
That's why I went to those knees. Watch this. Drives him off, comes back, gets some separation. Here comes the ball now. Just went down to make sure he's got the catch. But as you said, Dan, as soon as he catches the ball and his knees are on the ground, done.
Yeah, he's new to this game. He's a marvelous athlete. Jack, you got more on Jordan Kent, don't you?
Well, yeah, Jordan Kent is one of these guys that has set Oregon history, not in the football field, but with the number of different sports that he has lettered in. He made history when he became the first male athlete in history to letter in three separate sports. Now, this is his forte, running in track and field. But then he decided to try out for the hoop squad, and he was a great defensive player. And then, of course, we know the history as a wide receiver that he admits after last year, he's still learning the game. Did you ever letter in three sports, Dan?
Thank you, Jack, for that report.
You know, the thing about it, when you talk to the coaches about Kent, say a lot of guys are track athletes and try to be football players. He's a football player who happened to run track and is that versatile athlete.
Second and short for Oregon. Quick throw. Fine play by Marcus Walker. Crowd wants a flag. Working against Jason Williams, but Walker with good timing, apparently.
Well, earlier we saw Reggie Smith make a play like that, but his left hand was off the receiver behind him. I'm not sure this time if Walker's hand isn't. He's on his shoulder. He's riding him. There's a lot of contact. There should have been interference.
Non-reviewable play, though.
So we saw the correct way earlier by Reggie Smith, and there's Walker. Should have been a flag.
Third and three for Oregon. 20 seconds in the half. Swing to Stewart. He's got the first down. Oh, and he almost had more. So Oregon will be forced to use their last timeout. But again, the Ducks convert on third down. And again, it's Jonathan Stewart with a big play.
Big ol' IU, CJ IU's out of the ballgame. He's hurt. That's your defensive end.
Clock running. This will be the last play of the first half. The home run ball to the end zone, incomplete. Marcus Walker with another fine play on Jason Williams. And they've got 2 seconds left.
You can't defend any better than this. We talk Walker should have gotten a flag on the last one. Here he plays an inside out, uses the sideline for leverage, and plays this ball perfectly. Look how he separates the receiver from the ball by getting in between him with his body. Nicely done.
Ball underthrown by Dixon, not taking advantage of the 6'4", Jason Williams. So Martinez will come on from 48 yards out. He missed badly from 51. This one online and good.
Martinez is even shaking his head on that one. Are you kidding me?
Jack, you've got Bob Stoops with you.
Yes, I do. Coach, how do you change threes into touchdowns?
Well, penalties. We got the ball second down and two at the two. We've had a touchdown called back because of a penalty. We had to have some discipline, not hurt ourselves with some simple penalties. That's the biggest factor, and then two big plays on defense. So we're actually, with all that that's happened, we're sitting here in a good game.
Good luck, Coach.
Thank you, Jack. Paul Martinez, who was the Pac-10 Special Teams Player of the Week last week for his touchdown run against Fresno State, gets lucky on this one.
Led the nation in field goals made. This counts. There's no pictures and no statistics. Bam, hit the crossbar, and it went the correct way. Good.
It went the correct way if you're wearing green and yellow. The Paul Martinez field goal from 48 yards out increases the Ducks' lead to 7. 13-6 at halftime. You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC.
Or rhythms.
One of the questions for the Ducks coming into this game was how would they hold up at the cornerback position?
Well, Nick Aliotti told us that, but I think he knew these two corners can play. Redshirt freshman, they had to step up today. There's no question but the fact they did. How about Thurman with the big sack here? They came on the corner blitz. That's how much confidence they had. And look at Thurman with the coverage here. They bracket Kelly. They get him inside out. And then how about this? Here comes Bird. Make the tackle. Knock him out of bounds. They were loading the box. They were putting 6, 7, 8 guys in the box to stop Peterson. And then the corners are doing what Nick Aliotti knew they could do.
Take a look at our starting running backs comparison. Adrian Peterson and Jonathan Stewart. 7.1 yard average for Stewart is below his season average of 7.4. He also has caught 3 passes for another 19 yards.
Dan, let's summarize that first half just by saying Oklahoma 6 penalties, 0 for 6 on third downs, no touchdowns. Patterson just 50 yards.
That's summarizing it. Evenson with a low kickoff gets away and into the end zone where Adrian Peterson will down it. And the Sooners will take over at the 20-yard line. J- Jack caught up with Mike Bellotti and asked him why he put Brady Leaf in when Dennis Dixon was playing so well.
And Dan, his answer was that he felt that maybe they had lost a little bit of spark offensively. He said, I like to change things up now and again for two reasons. Not only, as Gary Croton told us, because Brady Leaf deserves the nod once and again, but allow Dennis Dixon to see it from the sidelines. I asked if we were going to see more of it, and he just shook his head.
First and 10 for the Sooners at the 20. Finley in motion. Peterson in the eye back. First carry for Peterson. He's got 4 yards. A.J. Tuatelli with the tackle.
Put an exclamation point to what we were just talking about. Pacific Life game summary. We'll summarize the game this way. And again, look at the penalties. 6 penalties for Oklahoma, and it killed them. It took them in and out of scoring position. 0-for-6 on third down conversions, no touchdowns. Peterson 14 carries, 50 yards. Not a good half for Oklahoma, and yet they're only down 13-6.
Fake to Peterson. Throw outside. Ian Pleasant with the catch. Short gain, if any. Now remember, Duck fans, don't get too excited here, because if you remember last year at halftime, at the Holiday Bowl in San Diego, the Ducks were up 7-3 and eventually lost 17-14 when Clint Ingram made a big interception as the Ducks were approaching field goal range.
Yeah, and that's a good point, Dan, and you were there, certainly. These two teams are so familiar with each other, they know their strengths and weaknesses.
And again, Adrian Peterson flanks all the way to the top of the screen on third down. Throw complete. Joaquin Iglesias with another catch.
Big George Robinson, the left guard's got to be careful. Big old Duke came in and put a block that was almost late there at the end of that play. They can't afford any more penalties.
First third down conversion for the Sooners. Mark the ball at the 33-yard line. Emmanuel Johnson now at the top of the screen. Fake to Peterson. Tuatelli falls down. And Thompson throws behind his receiver. Trying to get the ball to Brody Eldridge. A.J. Tuatelli and Blair Phillips with the pressure.
Dan, you're a Hall of Fame quarterback. How many times do you see that? He actually had gotten rid of the pressure, had gotten outside the pocket, and still rushed the throw when he had a receiver wide open. At that point, just relax, just dump it out to him. Take a look at this thing. He got outside the pocket. Here comes the pressure, first of all. Boom, steps up, gets back out. Now look, he's outside the pressure. Just dump it right there. Eldridge was wide open, nobody near him.
Easier said than done, my friend. Second and 10 for Paul Thompson and the Sooners. Finley in motion again. Here's a quick throw outside, too high for Emmanuel Johnson. In front of Walter Thurman. And Thompson knows he let one get away.
You quarterbacks do stick together, I'll tell you that. Protect each other.
I have a lot of admiration for Paul Thompson, what he's gone through in his career.
As I do, and what a class young man. When we sat down and talked with him at great length yesterday, good-looking kid. He and Peterson both light up the room when they smile.
Third and 10 now for the Sooners. Four-man rush for Oregon. Thompson, play clock running down. Quarterback draw up the middle. He's going to come up at the 40-yard line where he's tackled short of the first down. Jeremy Gibbs, who's back in the game for Oregon, made the tackle.
Just never really got in sync. They used every bit of the clock to get the play. And then once the quarterback draw got underway, he just stumbled his way through the hole and didn't get the first.
Cohen to punt. Jeremiah Johnson, who dropped the last Cohen punt, is back deep for Oregon. Now, this is a beauty. High and far, backing him up inside the 10. Drops another one. Now running for his life. He's going to go out of bounds at the 8-yard line. DeMario Pleasant forces him out there. Well, coming up next, we'll talk to a Hall of Fame running back and see how he sizes up Adrian Peterson and Jonathan Stewart. Yes, sir, the Pony Express rides again. Back at Autzen Stadium in Eugene, Oregon. Oregon will possess the ball at the 9-yard line for their first try here in the second half, ahead 13-6. James Finley back in the game, heading the slot position, top of the screen. Here's the hand to Stewart up the middle. And Corey Bennett wraps him up. Well, joining us on the mobile ESPN hotline is Hall of Fame running back Eric Dickerson. AD, how you doing, bud?
How you doing? What's going on, Dan?
Well, listen, Adrian Peterson's style has been compared to that of yours. Is there any validity to that?
For sure, Dan. When I saw him play, even in high school, I thought he ran quite a bit like myself. He's tall. He's 6'2", 2.5", 220. I'm 6'3", 225. So, I mean, he runs upright. But, you know, one thing I like about him, he's big and he's very, very fast, like myself.
Second and 8. Dixon throwing to the outside and almost intercepted by Marcus Walker. What a great reaction and break on the ball by Walker. Trying to get the ball outside to Jordan Kent.
Walker had it all the way, too. You thought he had the pick and the touchdown. Just a poorly thrown ball by Dixon. It was a miscommunication somehow with Dixon.
So, Eric, what do you think about Jonathan Stewart? I know you've watched him today.
You know, I watch Stewart. Stewart reminds me a lot of Barry Sanders, believe it or not, or LaDainian Tomlinson. You know, I know he has a bad ankle, but he has quick feet. He can, he's like a guy that can turn directions very fast. I mean, I like him as a Barry Sanders or a LaDainian Tomlinson type of running back. I think he'll be one of those backs that do very well in the National Football League.
Third and 8 for Dixon. And he throws incomplete to Jason Williams. Hurried that throw. Pressure from C.J. Ayu. And great start defensively for the Sooners.
You know, E.D., when we talked to Stewart yesterday, that's exactly what he said. He said he always looked up to Mr. Payton and those guys that have those quick feet, the guys that are a little bit shorter in stature. But you're right. He's got a heck of a career, doesn't he?
I think he has a great career, and you're right, because he does. He has that same body type as a Walter Payton or a Barry Sanders or a LaDainian Tomlinson. Low to the ground, like I said, quick feet, can change direction, you know, at a moment's notice.
So on fourth down from his end zone, Dragic with the punt to Reggie Smith. And he's going backwards.
And now a flag, and this is going to be, I think, against Oklahoma on their sideline. Personal foul.
And another penalty against the Sooners.
And it's going to take them out of Oregon territory. Edie, when you get a short field, what goes through your mind as a running back? Stewart's going to have that short field coming up here.
Well, I mean, one thing is, I mean, the score is 13-6. I think the main thing is they want to score a touchdown, but you have to establish that running game. You have Adrian Peterson. I like this guy. I said it over and over. He's big. He's fast. He's very powerful. And he can wear a defense down. I mean, that's what I like about it. It gives a quarterback a couple of different options when you have a back like him in the backfield.
So we've got offsetting personal fouls. Hey, listen, thanks for taking the time to join us this afternoon, Eric.
No problem. Thank you, guys.
Always fun to talk with you, partner.
Okay, take care.
See ya.
All right.
So Peterson now will get the short field to start this drive.
Eric the Great, Hall of Famer.
Here it is again. Anytime you get on the sideline, you get a lot of guys like that. They're still bumping and grinding over there, getting their last hits. Flags will fly.
47-yard line of Oregon. Peterson, right side. He's got some room. Oh, fine tackle by Jarris Bird, or Peterson was gone down the sideline.
Dan, this is what they were talking about. This is what E.D. was talking about. Eric Dickerson on the left, Adrian Peterson on the right. Stand-up runners, both big. They've got that great vision, great explosive speed, and very, very strong. Very similar in the styles when you watch them side by side.
No question about that, and we almost saw that live action of Peterson on that play. Here he is on second and 2. Tuatelli dives in there and takes his legs out. Remember, Tuatelli is taking over for Brent Haberle, who injured his right elbow, and he's done for the day. So this is depth of Oregon on defense.
And one of the biggest differences in the ball game so far has been the tackling of Oregon and the missed tackles by Oklahoma's defense. So if you look at the two defenses in this ball game, Oregon doing a spectacular job of one-on-one tackling, wrapping arms, making sure the ball carrier goes down.
Play clock running down, and they're still in the huddle. Remember, they used all three of their timeouts in the first quarter. They're going to use their first timeout of the second half here at the start of the third quarter.
Bob Stoops had to call it, and he's furious.
He's got every reason to be furious because he's not watching, but you are. ESPN College Football on ABC.
ESPN's College Football on ABC, brought to you by Chevrolet, America's brand, Chevy, an American revolution. The Home Depot, you can do it, we can help. And Allstate, are you in good hands?
4,000 Sooner fans have made the trek out here to Eugene, Oregon. They're hoping that the timeout called by Bob Stoops will result in a first down on third and one now. Thompson to throw for it. He's in trouble. Now he's got a man wide open. Iglesias inside the five. Iglesias down to the 1 yard line. What a throw by Paul Thompson.
Dan, what made that throw even more incredible was the pressure that Oregon got on him. Chung shaken up a little bit, came on the safety blitz. But watch this. Here's the bottom of your screen. Iglesias takes the middle. And just the throw was perfect from a guy who was under a lot of pressure and was actually hit as he released the ball. Terrific play. Third one, everybody thinks, okay, it's going to Peterson. But watch this. Chung on the backside. He's on his way down when he releases the ball and when he finds Iglesias. Big time play.
37-yard gain down to the 1 yard line on third and one, all arm by Paul Thompson.
Give it to Peterson now.
He's in the I formation. Thompson takes it forward on the sneak. No signal. Blair Phillips, AJ Tuatelli trying to hold him out.
You know, yesterday we talked at great length with Adrian Peterson. Just know the kind of guy he is. Look, he's looking over the sidelines now saying, give it to me. Give it to me. He's frustrated. He's a competitor. He wants the ball. Doesn't care how many guys are in the box or how they're stopping him. He wants the football.
Thompson is 6'4", 214. Looks like his helmet got over, but where's the ball? Tough to tell. Peterson, again a sneak. And this time, he's in. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Paul Thompson with a touchdown. And, you know, after that 37-yard throw, I'd give him a couple of pops at it, too.
Absolutely.
The one.
Absolutely. Plus, there's that theory, Dan, that you don't want to go away from the line of scrimmage when you're that close to the goal line. Take that step back to hand it, even if it's Peterson. I mean, the quarterback's right there. Just take it straight ahead.
I don't know. I think taking it back to Peterson at any time is good.
Oh, I agree. I'm saying there's that theory, and they certainly went to the quarterback sneak. I'm with you. I was calling for Peterson both plays.
I remember having a guy by the name of Chuck Muncy behind me. You talked about a big back who can get airborne and get in that end zone. I never ran that stupid sneak with him back there.
Well, I know if I'm on defense, I'm looking for 28, too.
Here's Garrett Hartley to tie the ball game. He does. So field position is the story here in the second half. Bad field position for Oregon. Good field position for Oklahoma, and a top performance by quarterback Paul Thompson. You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC. This is Separation Saturday in college football. A couple of critical tests throughout the top 25. We begin to separate the pretenders from the contenders. Notre Dame down 34-14 right now. Jeremiah Johnson and Andy L. Brown will be deep for Mike Bellotti's Ducks.
And it's gotten quiet in Autzen.
Yeah, the Sooner band's making noise in the left corner of this field behind Garrett Hartley. And he kicks this one. It may go out of bounds. And it does. Time to check in now with Matt Weiner with a SportsCenter in-game. Matt.
All right, Dan, LSU and Auburn, yards and points at a premium, but Auburn puts together a 12-play, 80-yard drive. Brandon Cox punched it in himself with the first touchdown allowed by the LSUD in 17 quarters. It's now 7-3. Louisville dominating the football game 24-7. Brian Brohm is out at the moment with a hand injury. We don't know if he'll be back, but the Cardinals winning by 17.
Thank you, Matt. First down and 10 for the Ducks at the 35-yard line after that kickoff went out of bounds. Jonathan Stewart on the right side of Dennis Dixon, and he gets it. Good blocking on the left side. Stiff arm. Shoulder. Walker knocks him out of bounds, but Nick Harris took one right to the face with the right hand of Jonathan Stewart.
Told you about this spread attack, and what they do is not only do they spread you, but then they'll zone block you, and everybody will come down. Everybody will come down this way, and then he'll come around and just try to find a hole. Now, let that roll and look at the zone blocking. Now, patience. Now, explode. Gets into that second level, looks for a block, and picks up 9 yards.
Rosario's got it in traffic into Sooner territory. What a strike by Dixon. Nick Harris on the stop, but that was a heck of a throw and catch.
And you had the feeling that Dixon needed that. He started the game 8 for 11, 130 yards, and was on fire. He was running the football, he was moving the football, and he was throwing the football. Since then, he went 4 or 5 of 14.
First and 10, Stewart, nothing on that left side this time. But you know that the short kickoff, the kickoff that goes out of bounds, placed on the 35-yard line, gave the Ducks instant momentum for this type of offense.
Absolutely, absolutely. Just another mistake by Oklahoma, which has made all kinds of mistakes and hurt themselves today. You heard Bob Stoops at halftime say we're hurting ourselves with penalties and stupid plays, and that's exactly what that kickoff was.
So a loss of 2 for Jonathan Stewart. Dixon fires to the outside, and Jason Williams has got it, and he's close to a first down.
Jason Williams.
Nick Harris on the tackle, but Stewart, or rather Williams, just lowered his head and drove forward close to that first down.
And Dixon threw that thing on a rope. I mean, he's got his confidence back. He's stepping into the throw. Here's the route. Williams slides to the outside, and the ball's perfectly thrown right around the face mask.
Lindy Holmes playing awfully soft there. Stewart up the middle, first down, Oregon. Jason Carter got him by an ankle.
Or he was gone. Carter doesn't make that tackle. There was nothing but daylight in front of him. So it's like the first Oregon drive.
Well, you notice the tempo. They're back to the no huddle, getting right to the line of scrimmage and calling the play. Here's Stewart again, right up the middle. He's got a couple inside the 30. Ball's loose, and the Sooners have got it. Darian Williams with the recovery of the Jonathan Stewart fumble. Rufus Alexander with the big hit.
Second fumble of the game for Oregon, and another huge break for the Sooners. That rubber band was stretching. Defense was given chunks.
Now, you know, sooner or later, that Rufus Alexander is going to make a play. He is to the Sooner defense what Adrian Peterson is to the Sooner offense.
This play's being challenged, being reviewed anyway. Every play of the ball game is being reviewed, but they're going to take a look at this one.
Oh, he was down. His knees were down, and that ball came out late.
All right, here he is.
Looks like his left knee, whole left side was down before that ball came loose.
Remember now, you need indisputable video evidence.
One thing, Oklahoma has not gotten many breaks today. They have made a number of miscues. They had a touchdown call back because of an illegal formation. Had the ball at the 2-yard line, and then had back-to-back motion penalties, and then a holding penalty. That drive resulted in a field goal. Dave Kataya on the headset to the men upstairs.
So this is not a challenge by the coach. This is just being reviewed. Every play is reviewed. And to overturn the call on the field, there has to be indisputable video evidence.
It's almost longer it takes, gives you the idea that perhaps this one will be reversed.
Well, you think so, right? I mean, you saw it. You said, absolutely. Here it is again. Watch his knee. Problem is, you can't really see the football. It looks like it comes out after the knee is out.
down.
This is probably our best look.
I agree with you. It looks like he's down.
And the key thing, as you said, Tim, about the replay review is,
well, I don't know.
There
it looks like the ball was out, or he was bobbling it.
There may not be enough evidence to reverse this one.
That was the replay right there. Let's take a look at that last play, that replay. Watch this. You tell me if this ball is out.
After review, there is no conclusive video evidence to overturn the call on the field. Therefore, the call stands. First down, Oklahoma.
First down, Oklahoma.
So both defenses coming up big here to start this second half. First and 10 from the 27-yard line for Paul Thompson. Eldridge in motion. Here's Peterson, right side, and he slips and goes down. Kwame Ajman and Matt Tawena there. And his feet just went out from under him.
Frustrating day for Adrian Peterson. Outstanding tackling and good defense. Tremendous containment by the defense. And this is what has been taking place all day. This is early on. Big old Linehan is there to make the tackle. Then look at all the green jerseys every time he touches it. They go low, they go high. They're double-teaming him. And the frustration at the end of the play by A.D.
Loss of one. Faked Tuatelli with the pressure. Great move by Thompson. But he can't get away from Blair Phillips. Got away from the pressure by Tuatelli. But Flint Phillips with another tackle for Oregon.
And it'll bring up another third and long.
Well, you got to like the way that Nick Aliotti's calling this game. Seems to have the right idea when to bring pressure on Thompson with another blitz from a linebacker.
He's been brilliant. Oklahoma on third down in the first half was 0 for 6. Here they're faced third and a little bit more than 10.
And 55,000 screaming Duck fans making noise. Third and 10. Clock running down again. Over the middle to Kelly. He's Whoa. Got it. And say goodbye because he's gone down the sideline. Malcolm Kelly, touchdown Oklahoma.
Jonathan Nelson on it. Touchdown.
Yeah. Oregon coaches are furious. They are convinced he stepped out when he crossed the 50.
Well, they might also be furious because the play clock appeared to have run all the way out. This is a juggling catch by Malcolm Kelly.
Might be furious, too, because they had a couple of defenders on him right there. Instead of tackling him, they let him go and tried to slap the ball.
Yeah, out of bounds right there. This one's got to come back. Oklahoma hurrying to the line to get this extra point off, but it's not going to work. Dave Kataya calls timeout. This one is under review, and this will not be an Oklahoma touchdown.
Mike Bellotti had the ear of the back judge, too.
You know, Willie Glasper literally bounced the ball up in the air so that Malcolm Kelly could get another shot at that.
It looked like Glasper had him in his grasp and then actually went to the ball and let him go, and he just exploded.
Yeah, he's clearly out of bounds.
Yep. He'll bring it back. Still a big play.
It's so similar to a play we saw a couple of years back when Oklahoma was playing Oklahoma State. That bedlam brawl. Juggled pass, went to the distance.
We saw a play just like this by Stewart. The first week of the season against Stanford stepped out, but that one was not reviewed. Almost in the same spot. I think they're already telling him he was out of bounds. I think they're trying to decide where.
I think he's trying to catch his breath. Dave huffing and puffing. He had to run about 60 yards to go to get the phone.
And the two of us can empathize with him.
Absolutely. Checking the spot now.
Absolutely.
still in, out right there. Well, what yard line is that? Looks like it's going to be, what is that, the 41? 39?
Well, as soon as Mark Amento tells me, I'll let you know. Mark, our man keeping the numbers upstairs, our spotter, Kelly Malibu Hayes, keeping his eye on things.
You put him on the
Thank
turf.
You, boys.
Yeah, Glasper had him in his grasp and just let him go and tried to slap the ball. Just should have let him make the catch and make the tackle. He's fair game anyway after he touches the football when it was in the air. Here we go.
This is the 48-yard line, and it is still in Sooner territory. Kelly's second catch of the afternoon. What an athletic one it was. He's got his win back. He's going to tell us all about it here.
That's what you think. He's still gasping over there.
In the eyes of the competitor, Paul Thompson.
After review, there is conclusive video evidence that the runner stepped out of bounds on the 47-yard line. Ball will be placed at the Oklahoma 47-yard line. First down. Clock should be adjusted to 4 minutes and 57 seconds.
So the clock is set now at 4:57. They move the ball back. Oklahoma's offense comes back out onto the field.
Second touchdown taken away from the Sooners this afternoon.
Good point.
Iglesias got robbed on a long one because of an illegal formation. And Malcolm Kelly's momentum robs the Sooners this time as he steps out at the 47-yard line.
And Glasper, the freshman, I'm sure was getting coached up during the review. They're telling him, once that ball's touched, go ahead and level the guy. Keep your arms around him. Don't let him go anywhere. Forget the football at that point.
Now, Dave Kataya, our referee, going back on the headset now. I think they misspotted this one. I think the 48 is the correct yard line.
After review, the spot is corrected. The ball will be placed on the Oregon 47-yard line. First down, Oklahoma.
So the ball moves into Oregon territory.
Could be a turning point in this game, huh?
Well, you know, Oregon's got to be a little bit concerned here. As you say, they've had two touchdowns. Oklahoma doesn't seem to have its A game with all the penalties and drops and misses. And yet, they're still tied, have the football, and they're moving into Oregon territory here.
First and 10 for the Sooners. Iglesias in motion again. Fake to Peterson. Throw to Iglesias, and he's got it. 35-yard line. Another fine throw on the run by Paul Thompson. And just the physical part is big for Thompson, Jack, but that leadership is so much more important.
Well, and we saw it when we came back from our last break when Paul Thompson was talking to all of his offensive linemen. But as upset or maybe as hyper as Adrian Peterson has been for all the first 30 minutes of this game, now into about 40 minutes of this game, Paul Thompson has been just the opposite. He's been very calm, very cool, very collected on the field, and especially when he's been off the field. Kind of makes sense to me when you realize he's been around for so long, Dan, that they call him Pops.
And he doesn't like it either, does he? He likes PT. First and 10 for PT and the Sooners. Jeremy Gibbs went out with an injury. Faetete in for Oregon. Here's Peterson, right side. Not much there, but look at that leg drive. Kwame Ajeman goes for a ride. Well, near the conclusion of today's game, we'll select the Chevrolet player of the game from each team. To honor their determination, Chevy will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund.
Nick Aliotti's got to be frustrated, the defensive coordinator for Oregon. His game plan was working to perfection, and they still have held Peterson to only 66 yards on the afternoon. He says Thompson's got to beat us. Well, now Thompson's starting to connect on these passes.
They've been hard yards for Peterson, too. Second and 6. Finley shifts. Thompson to throw. pump fake. Throwing to Kelly deep. He's got it. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Beating Walter Thurman. Malcolm Kelly with a touchdown grab.
That ball was perfectly thrown, just a little bit underthrown on purpose. Thurman had lost the ball. Boy, this is so nice. All right, here comes Kelly. Sit down, draw up Thurman, the freshman. Now try to run into the corner. A little push off by Kelly. Readjusts on the football because Thurman lost sight of it, and the touchdown.
So Kelly gets his touchdown reception. 31 yards. Oklahoma has their first lead of the afternoon, and Hartley adds to it. You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC.
Good coach, Nick Alioto.
A difference in the way that Thompson threw that deep ball and the way that Dixon has thrown it a couple of times today. Thompson's ball couldn't have been any better. Johnson looking for room to run. Now he's in big trouble. Jeremiah Johnson going backwards and down inside the 15-yard line. Jack, how about that Malcolm Kelly?
Yeah, don't be surprised if some of the Oklahoma faithful have a problem relating, because he's changed his number. You notice this year he's wearing number 4. It's in tribute, when he told me, to Roy Williams. Immediately I thought he meant the Roy Williams for Oklahoma, and I was a little confused. He says, no, Roy Williams, the wide receiver, dare I say it, to Sooner fans of Texas. Said he followed him all year long. Well, after that touchdown run, maybe the Sooner fans will forgive him.
Well, he is from Texas, Longview, Texas, Jack. Dixon on first and 10. Throws over the middle to Rosario. And what a catch in traffic. One more time by the big tight end, Dante Rosario. Between Darian Williams and Rufus Alexander.
Big, strong, tough body, soft hands.
14 yards on first and 10 for the Ducks.
And he too can get separation. Look at him sit down in the open area, the soft spot, make the catch. They just have to protect the football. Oklahoma's converted both Oregon fumbles to 10 points.
Stewart breaking tackles. First down, Oregon. Jason Carter couldn't bring him down. You know, the one thing Oregon hasn't gotten anything today is out of their quarterback, except on an ad lib type of run. Dixon has not carried the ball in the option at all today.
People forget about Jonathan Stewart coming into this ball game. Everybody was talking about Adrian Peterson. Stewart in high school ran for over 2,300 yards. He's got great speed, 32 touchdowns. That was just his senior year.
It's got Rosario one more time, and Rosario delivers the blow on Reggie Smith going out of bounds. And they're going to talk about it for a little bit.
Well, and this is what we talked about earlier, Dan. One of the things about this stretch offense last year, Oregon didn't use the tight end. They never, ever got him in there. He wasn't a point of emphasis, and they couldn't maximize it. Now they do with Rosario. That's 5 catches for 41 yards for Rosario.
Second and short. Stewart right side. First down, Oregon. Sooner territory down to the 45-yard line. Determined running by Jonathan Stewart, Latimer, and Harris on the stop.
And Oregon just took this up a notch. This drive, they're getting more physical, and Jonathan Stewart is leading the way. Incredibly productive running back, blocker, receiver. What a talent.
110 yards for Jonathan Stewart on 17 carries. First and 10 from the 45. Receiver screen to Finley. And he's got a few. He's close to another first down. Oregon looking to respond to Oklahoma's touchdown. Well, time permitting, stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report featuring scores and highlights with John Craig and Doug back in New York. And Finley is slow to get up. He was shaken up earlier in the game on the fumble on the punt return.
Couple guys down.
DeMarcus Granger, the redshirt freshman from Dallas, also down. Oregon's wide receivers continue to get hurt, it appears. Garen Strong was in for a couple of plays in the first quarter. He's not going to return. Cameron Colvin pulled a hamstring in the first quarter. He won't return.
And you're looking at DeMarcus Granger on the ground, and 6'3", 300-pound redshirt freshman. He was last year's top recruit. Severe pain. Look at the end of this play one more time. And here comes Finley. They look for number 96 coming at the end of this thing. Looked like he hit hard down on that shoulder and maybe twisted his back a little bit. Watch the way he hits. Makes the tackle. Comes down and just seems to twist once he gets down to the ground.
Hey, 6'3", a 300-pounder, showing great desire and hustle on that play to get in on that tackle. This is where the Sooners can ill afford an injury. Defensive tackle has been an area of concern for Bob Stoops as Finley continues to struggle on the Oregon sideline. Second and short again now for Oregon. Stewart in the backfield with Dixon. Fake to Stewart. Outside to Jason Williams. Oh, and a good tackle. Lendy Holmes comes up and stops him dead in his tracks. The former wide receiver with a good play.
He read it from the get-go, too. He saw the step off and then the step back for the little slip screen outside. He broke the ball quickly. Watch the top of your screen. All right, he reads the play. Look at him. And he's a full sprint now to make the tackle. Breaks down, hits him around the waist, wraps his arm, and drives him back.
And Ayu did a good job of coming out in pursuit, keeping Williams from turning it inside. Good double-team tackle there for the Sooners. Third and two now. Stewart, strength, power, first down Oregon. Zach Latimer is taken for a ride. Well, next week, Saturday Night Football features two fantastic regional matchups. Most of you will see Notre Dame try to exact some revenge as they take on Michigan State. Others will see USC battle Arizona. That's next Saturday, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC. College football lives here. First and 10 for Oregon. This is Stewart, left side. And a fine tackle there by C.J. Ayu.
Dan, Oklahoma's trying to get back that swagger that won them all those games in the first 7 years of Stoops' regime. Made them the baddest boys on the block. They aren't quite there yet. It's a young football team. I think they're still learning how to play defense. And one of the indications that it's not there yet is last year, Oklahoma was outscored in the fourth quarter 109-90. I mean, so they gave up 109 points just in the fourth quarter last year.
Pitch to Stewart. Sidesteps him and then trips himself. Great move on the corner, Jason Carter, and then he just lost his footing. And that's the way the third quarter will end, with Oregon on the move in Sooner territory. ESPN presentation of college football on ABC will return after this message and a word from our ABC stations. In Eugene, the Ducks on third down now and six. They've converted 7 of 12 today on third downs. Dixon throws, incomplete. Jason Carter knocked it away from Brian Pacinger. Jack, this injury list continues to grow for both teams.
Yeah, Dan, I'm starting to think like I'm at Gray's Anatomy rather here than here in Autzen Stadium. Let's start with DeMarcus Granger, defensive tackle for Oklahoma. He tweaked his back. They've stretched it. He's been cleared to return to play. Not the same for Jeremy Gibbs on the Ducks defensive line. He has injured his right ankle and is being iced. And James Finley, their wide receiver for the Ducks, the left ankle is the problem there, and he's still being taped. It's awfully tender.
Well, this is a tender moment, too. Fourth and six for the Ducks from the Sooner 30. Dixon to throw deep. He's got a man deep. Jason Williams, touchdown, Oregon. Fourth and six. They go for six and get it to number four. Martinez to tie this up.
Play is being reviewed.
Now Dave Kataya, our referee, tells us this play is being reviewed.
Just want to review the end of it, make sure he got in. Williams had separation right away. Says if we're even, I'm leaving. He's in there. That ball broke the plane.
Got behind Lindy Holmes for an apparent touchdown.
His feet are in. Still in. Ball's across the goal line.
Remember last week against Fresno State, he dropped a very catchable touchdown catch in the end zone. Got the start today for Garen Strong.
After review, there's conclusive video evidence. The call of the field is confirmed. Touchdown.
You know, the only new coach on this Oregon team is Robin Flugard, in charge of receivers. He's inherited a talented group. It's not like being brought in to teach Shaq how to shoot free throws or something. I mean, this group can play.
Robin's doing a heck of a job. Did a great job at Washington State with all their good receivers, too, last couple of years. So this is Martinez with the extra point. Leaf puts it down. Martinez puts it through.
Dan, the touchdown was set up, though, by the offensive line, giving Dixon plenty of time to sit back, read, and find Williams.
30 yards on fourth down and six. You are watching ESPN College Football on ABC. Back at Autzen Stadium, it may be separation Saturday, but there's no separating these two teams this afternoon. 11 seconds off the clock in the fourth quarter, and Oregon strikes on the 30-yard touchdown pass from Dixon to Jason Williams. This is Matt Evenson to kick off. Short kickoff. Peterson's got it. 20. Glasper's got him, and he gets out to close to the 30-yard line. Jack, what do you got?
Well, Dan, remember Jason Williams, as you alluded to last week, had a case of the drops. He's dropping a lot of balls. In fact, even early in this game, dropped a couple of them. Well, you would think that maybe his team might have turned on him. That was not the case. We asked Gary Croton about it, and he said the team has been very, very supportive. But if you remember, guys, he also pointed out that the only one that can build that confidence back is Jason Williams. He worked all week on catching the ball, and with that TD catch, I believe the confidence is back.
30-yard line is where the Sooners will start. Peterson stumbling forward. Cole Linehan first to meet him.
What a job by this defense on Peterson all day. Best running back in college football. He's got 19 carries for 66 yards. They've kept him bottled up all day, never away from the line of scrimmage. They contain him on the outside, force him in the inside, then get 3 and 4 green jerseys on top of it.
And yet, you still have the feeling that any time he can go the distance. Gets stronger as the game goes on. Give him a yard on that last play. Finley in motion on 2nd and 9. Fake to Peterson. Thompson in trouble. Another fine throw on the run. Joaquin Iglesias in front of Thurman. Well, let's check in now with Matt Weiner. Matt?
Dan, here's a vote for the Pontiac game-changing performance of the day. For the second straight week, BC needs double overtime to win. The game clinched by that interception from Jamie Silva. If you'd like to vote for your Pontiac game-changing performance, just log on to ESPN.com, and Dan, you can type in the keyword Pontiac.
I will do that, Matt. Personal foul penalty came in after this play.
After the play was over, dead ball. Personal foul on the defense. 15 yards beyond the run. Automatic first down.
Wow.
It's like Matt Tuena may have been the guilty party as Mike Bellotti addresses the situation. Big penalty. That will move the ball all the way into Duck territory. But what a throw by Thompson.
Throw by Thompson to pick up the first tag, 15 more on top of it. They're picking up yardage in chunks and now in Duck territory.
7 of 9 here in the second half with a touchdown pass.
Find out if they can break Peterson.
Tie ball game, 20-20. Eldridge in motion. Peterson left side. And J.D. Nelson wraps him up, but not before he has one of his better runs of the afternoon.
Well, you had the feeling they were going to try to break Peterson as they moved into Oregon territory, and they finally got the cutoff blocks they needed. Watch this now. He's going to his left side, and look at the offensive line. They slide down, they engage, they get the block, they hold him up just long enough, get him into the secondary. Weak block by Kelly, but he still picks up 5-7 yards after that, and he's a big guy for yaks. You know, yards after contact. Watch this. He's hit here. 1, 2, 3, still picks up another 5 yards after the initial contact.
16 yards total. Fake to Peterson this time. Incomplete. Thompson throwing short for Malcolm Kelly. Well, Monday night on ESPN continues as Joey Porter and a strong Steeler defense lead the Super Bowl champs against Byron Leftwich and the Jaguars. Is it Monday yet? Monday Night Football on ESPN, Monday at 8:30 Eastern. Also available in high def on ESPN HD. Call your cable operator or satellite provider today. Ball rests on the 26-yard line on 2nd and 10. Finley in motion one more time. Peterson with a carry one more time, and he's met in the hole. Blair Phillips from his middle linebacker spot read that play perfectly.
Frustrating day for Peterson. We just saw with a big game, but look at this. Gets into the hole. He's looking for daylight. There just isn't any. Green jerseys coming everywhere. Blair Phillips with a great job. Broke down, self-proclaimed homebody. Stayed at home that time and made the tackle.
3rd and 11 for Paul Thompson. Gives to Peterson left side. And he's close to a first down. Knocked out of bounds there by Walter Thurman. I wouldn't be surprised if Stoops goes for it on fourth down if Peterson was short with that dive.
Thurman comes up talking to Peterson too.
Probably saying, ouch.
Watch the end of this. Great explosion to get around the corner, then ducks that head and goes right after Thurman.
Peterson goes about 220. Thurman goes about 170.
See, the defensive
ouch.
Guy's got to get his angles over. He's got to punish the ball carrier no matter what his size is. Peterson is some kind of special, isn't he?
Yeah, and I think they got a special mark by the officials.
Easy now, big guy.
It's close. Inches.
Just short.
Well, earlier in the game, Thompson took a quarterback sneak in from inches away.
Two in a row. Ran the sneak twice.
Let's go, baby! Let's go! Let's go!
I like this call by Stoops, though. You've got momentum. Your offense is working very well here in the second half.
And you're on the road. Try to take the crowd out of it. Get the first.
And you've got Adrian Peterson in your backfield. Three tight ends for the Sooners. Finley, Eldridge, and Pleasant. Pleasant will line up as the fullback in front of Adrian Peterson. Peterson's got it. He's got a first down and more. High step and touchdown, Adrian Peterson. Great block by George Robinson, the Duke. And Stoops is rewarded by a touchdown from Adrian Peterson.
Oregon jammed that defensive line really tight. waiting for the sneak or Peterson to get that half yard. And they didn't have anybody in the secondary level. Look at this running room right here. I mean, there's nobody back there. Everybody jammed up front to stop the short yardage. No safety valves.
So Hartley will try to increase the lead to 7. And he does. Oklahoma's last 2 touchdowns came on 4th down plays. The bomb to Malcolm Kelly, then the gut shot by Adrian Peterson, 17 yards, touchdown. We'd like to welcome those of you who have been watching the Miami-Louisville game, and I think you're going to be happy to watch this one. This one's going back and forth here in the second half, isn't it, Tim?
No question about it. Oklahoma outscored Oregon 14-0 in the third period to take a 20-13 lead. The Ducks came roaring right back and tied it up, and Adrian Peterson just exploded on 4th down and inches. Oregon jammed the line, short yardage, didn't have a safety back there, and once he broke that first level and got into the secondary, see you later. Peterson has given Oklahoma the lead.
Giving his offensive line a lot of credit. That's what I'm talking about, as he says. Over 100 yards rushing now.
Mesner, Robinson, Cooper, Walker, Braxton, all the big guys up front. Gave him a huge hole.
Hartley will kick off. Chris Vincent. And number 27, Andiel Brown, deep for Oregon. This is Vincent to the 20, 25-yard line, then out of bounds.
Game has gone back and forth. Oregon scored first to get this game going. Crowd was going crazy. Sellout crowd, fire marshal crowd. Then in the second half, this is Thompson on 3rd down and long. A lot of pressure coming on the blitz. He threw a strike, got it down to the 1. Thompson with the quarterback sneak gave him the lead. This is what we're talking about now in the third quarter. This touchdown pass to Kelly. They outscored him 14-0 in the third. Dixon came right back. Threw a strike, and then Peterson on short yardage, 4th and inches, explodes. Nobody in the secondary. Peterson now with 109 yards for the game.
Dixon on 1st down rolls, almost intercepted. It is intercepted. Nick Harris gets the deflection, and the Sooners are back in business. First interception thrown by Dennis Dixon all year long, and what a horrible time for it to happen for Duck fans.
And look out, folks, the floodgates could be opening here. Oregon dominated the first half of play, but Oklahoma now wearing them out, and turnovers have made the difference. Dixon again with plenty of time. Throws right into coverage, and Latimer tipped the football before it was intercepted. Great play by the linebacker, Zach Latimer.
This Oregon defense has been on the field an awful lot here in the second half.
That was a gift for Nick Harris, the nickelback. Ball came right to him after the tip.
3 turnovers for Oregon, none for Oklahoma. And Thompson is going to throw. He's in trouble now. Now he throws it away. Heads up play by Paul Thompson.
And Dan,
we do have a flag down. Excuse me, Tim. Kwame Ajiman with the pressure. We'll check out what this flag's all about.
The 2 turnovers, the 3 now, but the first 2 turnovers turned into 10 points for Oklahoma. And again, Oklahoma with this turnover in scoring position. I mean, great field position.
And you really can't blame the illegal receiver for being downfield. Perhaps he thought that Thompson was going to run with his ball when he got that pressure. Oklahoma's offense really performed well as of late. They've scored touchdowns in the last 3 drives.
Well, Oklahoma's got a very young offensive line. Remember now, Frank Romero, he went from defense to offense, became all Big 12. Jamal Brown, the same thing. He was a first-round NFL pick. Now they're loaded with young guys up front. Mesner, the only senior. And the offensive line for Oklahoma has really played well, especially the second half.
2nd and 10 after the Ducks turn the penalty down. Here's Peterson, left side, breaking tackles inside the 30, inside the 20, and down.
Oh, that was an awkward fall.
Kwaji Agyeman with the tackle there, and Peterson grabbed his right leg immediately. 20 yards on the gain, but he's up and back in the huddle.
It's the second time he's been pulled down from behind like that and twist his leg. Also has lost a lot of skin on his shins from the turf. He's got that bandaged up, but look at this, how awkward this is on his leg.
Wow. That could have been a knee, an ankle.
Or a hip.
Or a groin.
We got him all covered.
He's okay, though. Man of steel. Right now, Oregon's getting worn out by the
Sooner offense. The 22nd clock did not start. Therefore, the entire clock, game clock, will be reset to 10 minutes and 56 seconds. 10, 5, 6.
Dan, just from what we've seen the last couple of plays, it would be a shock to me if Peterson sticks around next year to put another 300 or so carries of mileage on that body.
It would be a shock to a lot of people. It would be a shock to him, too. Without separation Saturday here in Eugene, Oregon. Dan Fouts, Tim Brandt, Jack Root with you. I want to welcome those of you who are going to tune into a pretty good ball game here. Adrian Peterson right up the middle, flag down. And this is exactly where Oklahoma killed themselves in the first half with penalties when they're in the Oregon red zone.
Just talked about how young the offensive line is. It looks like a holding penalty. But it was Mesner, the senior, who got the penalties in the first half. Bob Stoops is furious.
Holding. Offense. Number 79. 10-yard penalty. Remains replay first down.
And it's Mesner again, the senior.
That's the first penalty called against Stoops' offense in the second half. Pushes him back to the 25-yard line where it'll be first down and 20. Eldridge in motion. Peterson left side. Looking for the corner and not finding it. A.J. Tuatelli and Walter Thurman with the stop.
Adrian Peterson, 6'2", 218 pounds. In his career, when you look at all his numbers, 62% of all his yards came in the second half. This is what we're talking about. He gets stronger as the game gets on. That's why his nickname is AD all day.
23 touchdowns in the second half for all day Adrian Peterson. Finley in motion on second down. Again, it's Peterson left side inside the 20. Thurman takes him out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. And Adrian Peterson is just wearing out this Oregon defense right now.
Well, and he's become more of a complete back. They've made him a better receiver, which gets him out of crowded spaces and forces linebackers and safeties in to cover him. He's tough on the outside edge. He gets inside blocks. He's patient, and he lets his eyes move his feet. He reads the hole and explodes in through it.
Oregon substituting. Five guys went out there trying to get some fresh bodies in the game on this third down. And Thompson's going to call timeout. Play clock running down. Some confusion. Heads up move by Paul Thompson. So it'll be third down and 9 when we come back. Right now you're watching ESPN College Football on ABC.
ESPN's College Football on ABC, brought to you by Hummer, like nothing else. Aflac, ask about it at work. And Singular, raising the bar.
Welcome back to Autzen Stadium, where the Sooners lead it by 7. They're already in field goal range here on this 3rd and 9. You're Bob Stoops. What do you call?
Peterson, baby. Peterson and Peterson. He's got 90 yards this half. He had 50 in the first half, 90 this half. He's just getting warmed up.
Well, we'll see, Coach Brandt. He's in the I formation. Finley in motion. Peterson's got it right side. Huge hole inside the 10, inside the 5. First down, Oklahoma. Adrian Peterson behind the big block by Ian Pleasant, his fullback.
You don't have to be a Phi Beta Kappa to know that Peterson is the guy that needs the football in his hands to make things happen. Cooper, the center, now is down on the field. A couple of Oregon Ducks are down on the field. Fatigue becoming a factor in a very, very physical football game.
Right, you can see just how far down the field middle linebacker Blair Phillips is before he gets to Adrian Peterson.
You look at the end of that run, though, and you can see the strength that Peterson has. He just keeps driving. The legs keep moving no matter how many guys are trying to hit him and pull him down.
Special is the word for Adrian Peterson.
Well, he finished second in the Heisman 2 years ago with almost 2,000 yards. I thought he should have won it, but he was a freshman, and they didn't want to give it to him. Last year, he had that high ankle sprain and still had over 1,100 yards to lead the Big 12. Now he's becoming more of a receiver. I mean, he's just going to be a great pro. He's a great player. If you look at the numbers and you look at what he's done and what he continues to do, 90 yards in the second half. Unbelievable. 101 yards in the second half. Incredible. And he does so many things. I say he uses his eyes to move his feet. He waits for his blocks. He explodes inside. Once he gets to the second level, DBs aren't big enough to really punish him. They'll pull him down, but they don't punish him. He punishes them. Look how he puts his head down. And then, of course, the touchdown, high step ins. He's got a great feel for where the defenders are, knew no one was around him, and he's just getting warmed up. Just gets better and better as the game wears on.
With this injury to John Cooper, he'll be replaced by Chase Beeler, who's a true freshman from Jenks, Oklahoma. Tough spot to get your first action as a true freshman. It appears that Cooper's limping on his left side, which is good news because he had that horrible injury to his right ankle last year.
Dan, the Sooners added some new wrinkles last week, lining up in a 5-wide receiver set. They also did a 4-wide with the tight end in the slot. And we've seen it a couple times today where they put Peterson out wide with the receivers in an empty backfield. But when it all is said and done and the game's on the line and it's a tight situation, then they're coming back with Peterson in that backfield and they're just going to line him up and point him. They can tell the defense where he's going. He's still going to get his yardage.
Beeler with his first snap. It's a good one. Peterson's got it left side and Phillips has got him short of the goal line. This is where some of those new timing rules will come into effect and will be a detriment to Oregon's attempts to get back into this one.
Good guess by Nick Aliotti, the defense coordinator, on that last play. They overloaded to the right side of the defense. That's where Peterson was going. They tried to run a trap, but they stopped him.
Second and goal. Finley moving. Fake to Peterson, throw incomplete. Trying to get the ball to Pleasant. And even if he had caught the ball, I think his momentum would have carried him out of bounds, short of the goal line.
Peterson looking over the sideline, hitting his number 28 on the chest, like, give the ball to me.
You know, the injury timeout may have given Oregon a second breath. Chance to catch their breath.
Nick Aliotti with a great game plan has outguessed him twice here down by the goal line.
Peterson deep in the I formation. Third and goal. Peterson up the middle. Nothing there.
Stoned him.
Blair Phillips among the tacklers. J.D. Nelson as well. I'm surprised with a freshman center in the game that the Sooners would attack right up the middle.
Boy, watch Blair Phillips, though. Gets into the hole, meets him right here, tuck the tail, sky the eyes, now driving backwards. Help is on its way. Great play by 33, Blair Phillips, the leading tackler on this defense.
So Hartley will come on to increase this Sooner lead to 10. Ball will be placed at the 20-yard line by Hayes McEachern. Derek Shaw with the snap. Good snap, good hold, good kick. So Oklahoma increases their lead to 10 with 6:45 to go in the fourth quarter. When we come back, it'll be Jonathan Stewart's time on offense for Mike Pilati's Ducks. And don't forget about this man, Dennis Dixon, the Oregon quarterback. You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC. It's Separation Saturday in college football. We are starting to separate the pretenders from the contenders. And Oklahoma starting to separate from Oregon with a 10-point lead. Hartley to kick off.
Yeah.
And it's a good kickoff. Oh, all the way back into the end zone. Andy L. Brown will touch a knee down, and the ball will come out to the 20-yard line. It's time now to check in with Matt Weiner with a SportsCenter in-game.
Well, Dan, for those of you who have been watching Louisville-Miami, it is now a final. Cardinals win it after dominating the game, really at the line of scrimmage. Showed off the speed as well. It's their first win over Miami at 11 tries. And there's now a celebration on there, the kind of which normally associated with Hoops and Horses Day.
Thank you, Matt. So the Ducks will start 80 yards away from the Sooner goal line on first and 10. Stewart in the backfield, and he gets it up the middle. He's got a first down. Jonathan Stewart with another nice run right through the heart of the Oklahoma defense. Rufus Alexander with the stop.
Got some hosses in this game. This is a measure stick game, as Mike Pilati called it for his ball club. They're getting the exposure nationally that they hoped they would get. They're playing against Oklahoma, but they feel like they've got to get a win to get the attention of the BCS against Oklahoma.
The pitch to Stewart on the option. He's got about 8 yards and then out of bounds, stopping the clock. Oregon has never beaten Oklahoma. 0-6.
No, and to be honest, Oregon's helped them. I mean, Oklahoma leads 30-20, and 13 points have come off of three Oregon turnovers. So, I mean, it's almost been a gift for the Sooners.
No turnovers for the Sooners. Second and one. Option Dixon, first down Oregon, and Rufus Alexander's got him. Well, this season's premiere of Grey's Anatomy Thursday night at 9/8 Central. Make a move with TV's hottest doctors to a new season and a new night.
Dan, with the new clock continuing to roll at 6:01, they've got to be conscious now of that clock. This is a hurry up, up tempo type offense. They've got to move it. They need two scores.
Three wide receivers to the top of the screen. Dixon looks to the bottom of the screen. Got Jason Williams. Williams out of bounds, and he's close to a first down.
I thought he had it. He reached across the marker. They didn't give him the mark that he thought he had.
He got the first down, though.
Move the chains.
Smart read by Dixon, finding the single coverage on the single receiver side and getting out of bounds. Rosario and Kent to the bottom of the screen now. Williams to the top. Paysinger in the slot. Dixon over the middle. Intercepted. Intercepted by Nick Harris, his second of the game. Trying to go one more time inside to Jason Williams, but Harris is all over it. Two interceptions for Harris here in the fourth quarter.
And Dixon came into this ball game. He hadn't been sacked all year. He hadn't thrown a pick all year. And here's his second. Again, he got pretty good protection. Just throws into coverage. And not well thrown. Williams never had a chance to make the catch. White jerseys are everywhere. Harris, the nickelback, just sat there and waited.
Good call by Brent Venables. Going to the zone there. Trying to eat up time. Got the interception. Here's Peterson, left side, 40, out of bounds, near midfield, close to a first down.
Peterson out of bounds.
Last time now to check in with John Saunders in New York. John?
Well, Dan, we just want to remind everyone that Pete Carroll and USC will face Zach Taylor in Nebraska.
coming up on Saturday Night Football. That's at 8 o'clock Eastern time. Back to Dan and Tim.
Thank you, John. Trojans are tough.
You know, right now, Mike Bellotti's got to be shell-shocked. His team dominated the first half and pretty much had their way in the third quarter early until Oklahoma took over a couple turnovers. They turned them into points, steamrolled that into 14 third-quarter points. Now they're in control of the game.
First and 10 for Peterson, right side, and he's rolling now. Another 9-10-yard gain for Adrian Peterson on first down. Brandon Braxton, the sophomore from Youngstown, with a big block. Jack, Adrian Peterson is responding, wouldn't you say?
Yes, indeed, and he had to respond after the first game against UAB when Kevin Wilson, the offensive coordinator, scolded him despite the fact that he rushed for 139 yards and a TD. He said, you didn't pick up your pass protection right. You didn't run with the reckless abandon, and you tried to be too fancy. You know what Adrian Peterson did? He apologized to the team.
No apology necessary today as he breaks the tackle down the sideline, inside the 5-yard line, where he's horse-collared and thrown out of bounds. Patrick Chung, among others.
And he's slow to get up, but what a talent.
At some point, he's got to get tired, doesn't he?
That might be a door slammer. You know, with the ready-to-play rule to speed up the game this year, you might lose 18 seconds or so on every possession. So when you look at what Oregon has with 4:20 left in the ballgame, they're running short when they need two scores now, and it looks like it's going to be three. Now Peterson over 200 yards for the game. 33 carries, 206 yards, and a touchdown. You know, it looked like at the end of this play, he slowed down. Right here, it's like he gives himself up to the tackler, and then he comes up and gets him around the head, and again he falls funny. I see how he just kind of gave himself up, and when his body went limp, that's when he took the hit and went down hard on that right side.
Vicious tackle by Patrick Chung. Legal.
Surprised he didn't run out of bounds here. Well, he was trying to run out of bounds. That's why he gave his body up.
We came in talking about these two fine running backs. Peterson has had a typical second half for the Sooners. Jonathan Stewart for the Ducks, a productive day as well, but four turnovers is just too much to overcome when you're going up against a team as talented and as determined as the Sooners.
Well, Oklahoma trying to get the swagger back that won them all those games in Stoops' first 7 years. That made them the baddest boys on the block in the Big 12, and it looks like they're getting that back. This is a very young Oklahoma football team. And Adrian's up and walking off. Well, Stewart had the advantage in the first half, and since then, Peterson has just run away. 33 carries, 206 yards. They're both averaging over 6 yards a carry, and both have one touchdown.
Time permitting, stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report, featuring scores and highlights with John, Craig, and Doug back in New York. And there's plenty of highlights to show from this one. Alan Patrick will take number 28 spot in the Sooner backfield. First and goal.
AD smiling when he came off, though, so he's okay.
Finley in motion. Movement up front. Fake to Allen. Thompson cannot fool or get around Patrick Chung. Oregon's got to start thinking about when to use some timeouts. They have 3 timeouts to use.
It's a good call, coach, because they're going under 4 minutes now, and they've got 2 scores they've got to get. They've got to hold them here and then get 2 scores. But you're right, they've got to manage the clock.
The problem is if you call timeouts, you give this man time to catch his breath and get back in the game. Second down now from the 11-yard line. Alan Patrick in the I formation. He gets it right side. J.D. Nelson, A.J. Tuatelli on the stop at the 10-yard line.
Got to take a timeout. Got to take a timeout.
There you go, coach. Mike Bellotti with the timeout call.
3:23 to play.
Timeout. Oregon.
So So Adrian Peterson makes his way back to the Sooner huddle. 3:23 to go. You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC.
Time for the Pacific Life game summary. 3:24 to play. Oklahoma up 10, and I'll show you why. Adrian Peterson has just gone off in the second half. 19 carries, 156 yards, and a touchdown in this half alone. How about the fourth quarter? 14 carries, 140 yards. Just in the fourth for AD. And Oregon just giving them gifts. The turnover on the kickoff. The interception. And Harris has two of them here in the second half. And that has turned into 13 points.
And Peterson's got it on third and goal. Left side. And out of bounds. And that'll stop the clock, and that's a real big benefit to Oregon. A.J. Tuatelli with another tackle. And stopping the clock as Garrett Hartley comes out to try to add to this 10-point lead for Oklahoma.
Well, good pursuit again by the Oregon defense. They got blocks all the way to the side, and Peterson waited for his blocking, but by waiting for his blocking, he allowed the pursuit to catch him and take him out of bounds. So he tried to stay in. He just couldn't fight against the defense.
Hartley has been perfect this afternoon. 3 for 3. In fact, he's 7 for 7 on the year. 22-yard attempt here from a severe angle. McEachern puts it down, and Hartley puts it through. Garrett Hartley with his third. Make that his fourth field goal of the afternoon.
Which tells the Ducks that they now need two touchdowns, and they've got to do it in 3 minutes and 12 seconds. So we'll see how Mike Bellotti now manages the clock and tries to get his offense from turning the ball over. 16 points off 4 Oregon turnovers.
That will just kill you, especially when you got somebody like Adrian Peterson, right, Jack?
Oh, Adrian Peterson, we all had a scare there for a moment when the athletic trainer had to go out. But you know what it was, fellas? He was just, as Keith Jackson would say, plum tuckered out. He's fine here on the sidelines. I'm watching him. He's back with his mates here, listening to Cale Gundy give him the last-minute update on what they need to do in the final 3 minutes. Had a big smile on his face just a couple of moments ago. He's fine, so everybody can breathe a collective sigh of relief.
This crowd of 59,269. About 4,000 Sooner fans came all the way to Eugene. That's a stadium record, and it's the largest crowd ever assembled in the entire state of Oregon.
Fire marshal game.
Hartley will squib this one down the field. And it'll go out of bounds. That's another break for Oregon. Danielle Brown let it go out of bounds. Ball will be placed on the 35-yard line. It's time for a look at our ESPNU All-State standing review.
Well, Ohio State rolls once again. Notre Dame getting blistered by Michigan. Fell behind big early. Auburn's got a pretty good way. Now it looks like it's going to be wide open for the Tigers. And of course, big game USC Nebraska later.
Dixon on first and 10. Fakes to Stewart. Pressure. Now he's going to run. He'll get about 6, but he needs a whole lot more than that.
Dixon on the keeper for the 42.
Ducks have 2 timeouts. Clock continues to roll as the receivers slowly get back to the line of scrimmage. Jason Williams heading for the sidelines, and he gets out of bounds. Marcus Walker pushes him out. First down, Oregon. But Oklahoma will give that type of play to the Ducks every day.
That's exactly right, because right now, if you look at the defense and they're being instructed from the sidelines, keep everybody in front of you. As long as they keep them in front, they don't care if the clock stops momentarily, because once they set it, boom, it's going again. Just keep everybody in front of you.
First and 10 from midfield. Stewart up the middle, and he's tripped up by his own lineman. Anoka Lucas was pushed back. That tripped up Jonathan Stewart.
This will probably take it under 2 minutes. They've got to hurry up. They've got to get it going.
gain of two. Dixon to the outside. Williams has got it. And he smartly steps out of bounds at the 30-yard line in front of Reggie Smith. Stops that clock. Well, it's an all-new fall season of Extreme Makeover, Home Edition. We're going to the ends of the earth, starting with Alaska, on our way to all 50 states. Two-hour season premiere next Sunday, September 24th at 7, 6 Central. And tomorrow night, catch a preseason special. Dixon's got Rosario over the middle down to the 25-yard line. Clock continues to roll. Gain of six on that one.
But they're being fairly efficient with the clock. 1:46 left. They're still moving the ball. They're almost down to the red zone. Get a score. Think about the onside kick. Then measure the clock again.
Well, Bilotti calls timeout. Today's Chevrolet players of the game are quarterback Paul Thompson of Oklahoma and number four Jason Williams of Oregon. In recognition of their efforts, Chevy will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. And you say, how can you not give it to Adrian Peterson?
How can you not give it to Adrian Peterson?
The leadership factor of the quarterback, Paul Thompson, completing passes in pressure situations, especially that fourth down when he went for the bomb and got Malcolm Kelly.
Has nothing to do with you being a quarterback.
Well, he played without any mistakes today. And I know this man. All day. Toby Keith on the sideline, big Sooner fan. Happy he made the trip to Eugene.
Well, see that all day. That refers to Adrian Peterson, a nickname AD. 34 carries, 211 yards, and the touchdown. Spectacular afternoon. And I'm with you 100% on Jason Williams. What an afternoon he had. Eight catches, 158 yards, and a touchdown for the Ducks.
Ducks need a score in a big hurry.
I know nobody's leaving this stadium.
Ball on the 25-yard line. Bad snap through his legs. Dixon goes down. And you talk about a killer play at the worst possible time. A low snap from Anoka Lucas goes between the quarterback's legs, and they lose a bunch of yards.
And losing time. The clock continues to roll. The receivers were down by the end zone. Now have to get all the way back.
Dixon steps up. Now he throws. He's got Williams again on the sidelines. And again, he gets out of bounds, 16-yard line. Now you got to start putting the ball in the end zone and letting these tall receivers of Oregon, especially Williams, go up and try for one.
Yeah, and this is where Mike Bilotti now is cursing that new rule under his breath. Boy, the new clock rule really shortens the game when you're in your hurry-up offense down the stretch.
First and 10 from the 16. Dixon steps up. He's going to run.
Five, he's got it.
10. Touchdown, Oregon! Dennis Dixon from 16 yards out.
What a football game. And a great read by Dixon.
He just ran away from people, too. First time the second half he's gotten loose on the ground. Martinez with the extra point. Perfect. 1:09 to go in the fourth quarter from Autzen Stadium in Eugene. Don't go anywhere. This one's not over yet. You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC. One timeout. You've got to anticipate the onside kick here for Oregon.
And they know if they don't get it, Dan, it's over. They've got to get the onside kick.
And it's the coach's kid who's going to kick it. Luke Bilotti, the junior from Sheldon High School here in Eugene, will attempt this onside kick. And Oklahoma calls their last timeout.
And the reason they call that timeout, they wanted to see the alignment of the onside kick team. They wanted to see how they would line up and which onside kick they were going to try to perform.
Tonight, a resurgent Nebraska team heads to L.A. in search of an upset as they take on number 4 USC. Saturday Night Football presented by Southwest Airlines. Tonight, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC. College football lives here, and it's another Big 12 Pac-10 matchup on Separation Saturday.
Bob Stoops telling his sure hands team that all they have to do is recover this thing, make the catch, and the game's over.
Yes, it is.
And a smart thing to do is even step up. That ball's got to go 10 yards before the defense, before the kicking team can get to it and recover it legally. So attack the football if you're the sure hands team.
Yeah, and the benefit that Bellotti has is artificial surface. The ball just seems to, if you hit it right, get the right bounce, it'll go way up high in the air and give the kicking team a real good shot at it. You can see all the athletes for Oklahoma on the field. Wide receivers, running backs, defensive backs.
A lot of adjustments being made by the Sooners.
Here's Luke Bellotti. Buggy wants to kick it to the left side now. Oregon shifts over there. Ball's loose. Ducks the ball.
Do you believe it?
Got the high bounce. And then the wrestling match at the bottom, and Oregon comes out with it.
Oklahoma.
Patrick Chung may have been at the bottom there.
But hold on, Oklahoma's got the football. And they're saying, wait a minute, the pileup's over there. We've got the ball over here.
But if this goes to review, it's going to be awful difficult to reverse this call. Question is, does the ball go 10 yards before it's touched by the receiving team?
It's actually hit before 10 yards, and it's hit by an Oregon player. That's illegal.
Was taken away. First down.
Well, I don't know. That ball was touched before it went 10 yards. But it's going to be first down. Ducks. Well, shouldn't be.
Stoops can challenge this. He has a timeout. Well, he used his timeout on the kickoff when they made the adjustments on the onside kick, so he cannot challenge us, but it is reviewable, as every play is in college football.
No question in my mind, it was touched first by an Oregon Duck, and it didn't go 10 yards before he touched it. Now they're going to go over and look at this play and review it. Take a look at this thing. You tell me if it goes 10 yards, and you tell me who hit it first.
That's the question, who hit it first? Great kick by the coach's son, Luke Bellotti. Oregon touched
it
first.
No question. That was Oregon. And it didn't go 10 yards.
May have been Brian Paysinger, number 19. That's awful close from that angle.
Keep in mind, it's got to be indisputable video evidence. This is a good angle right here. Go up for it.
Malcolm Kelly way up in the air, number 4 for Oklahoma. Chung did get the recovery.
Should be Oklahoma football, but instead, Oregon's offense is on the field. That's a good replay right there. Oregon touched it first before they crossed the line.
This is from the coach's camera. Got to agree with you, Tim. Ball appeared to be hit by Brian Paysinger, number 19, right there before the ball traveled 10 yards.
There's no question in my mind, Dan. It's got to be Oklahoma football. And I know that's not what this record crowd wants here at Austin Stadium. But if they're going to use replay properly, they're reviewing the play, and there's indisputable video evidence that it was touched first by Oregon before it went 10 yards.
Strike up the band in hopes that this call stands. 106 to go. If Oregon has the ball, they'll have one timeout. But they've got to get in the end zone for a touchdown. Still checking to see if this ball did go 10 yards. This is Dave Kataya, our referee from the Pac-10 Conference. Luke Bilotti with the kick. The touch by Pacinger there. The recovery by Oregon. And now the review.
Well, there's no question the ball went 10 yards after it was batted. The proper call is it was batted before it went 10 yards right there. And it was touched by Oregon, and that's illegal. And here comes the call.
After review, there's conclusive video evidence that the ball was touched by a receiving team player, which makes the ball live. Oregon ball.
That's a bad call. That's a bad call. The ball was touched first by an Oregon player, not the receiving team, not Malcolm Kelly. So the Ducks get an incredible break. They'll have the ball at the 48-yard line, 106 to go, one timeout to work with. Horrible call by the review referee. Dixon over the middle to Stewart. 45-yard line, heading for the sidelines, 40 out of bounds. Jonathan Stewart with the speed to take it from the middle of the field all the way to the sideline.
The call is a moot point now. 54 seconds left for the Ducks. There's plenty of time. No panic is necessary. They've got time using the sidelines and timeouts. No timeouts are left for Oklahoma. One is left for Oregon. So Oregon in the catbird seat there. They just have to manage this clock.
37-yard line for Dixon. Over the middle. He's got incomplete. Flag down. Flag comes in. Darian Williams may get called for pass interference on Brian Pacinger. Oklahoma came with a blitz. Oklahoma had to play man-to-man in the secondary, and the free safety Williams is going to get called. Boy, the Oregon Ducks were dead Ducks until that call. Sooners led 33-20 with 3 minutes and 12 seconds remaining in the
pass
game.
Interference defense number 41.
Automatic first down.
First down.
Dan, now they really don't have to rush.
They got to rush a little bit. They do have 50 seconds. And you know what, Tim? You're right, because they do have one timeout.
No, that's exactly right. They've got the sidelines. They've got one timeout. They do not have to rush. As a matter of fact, they want to melt the clock. Touchdown and an extra point gives them the game.
If you're Oklahoma, I would keep my eye on number 4, Jason Williams. He's had a huge game for Oregon.
9 catches, 177 yards and a touchdown, I'd say.
Last play will be reviewed.
Well, that'll get the Boo Birds going.
They're thinking they got zipped.
Now the reason for this review is there's a question out whether the defense at the line of scrimmage may have tipped this ball before that contact. And you know what? It looked like CJ Ayu, the defensive end, may have touched the ball. So that would negate that flag right there, and Oregon would have an incomplete, be second down and 10.
Again, it's got to be indisputable video evidence, but we've got a pretty good shot of it. Watch the bottom of your screen. Right here, 99. Looks like he changed the flight of the ball, because then it becomes a wobbling dead duck, so to speak.
Easy. No, you're right. CJ Ayu with a heck of a play. That ball, Dennis Dixon always throws spirals. That ball was not a spiral when it got to the receiver.
But again, Dan, indisputable video evidence, and I'm not sure it's there. I mean, I saw it on the onside kick. I don't see it there.
Question is, what are they seeing upstairs? Because the call on the onside kick was ridiculous.
Take a look at the bottom of your screen. There's the hand, bam, and the ball changes direction. See that? almost starts going end over end.
I'm not sure there was pass interference on that play. Looked like pretty good coverage by Williams.
So much for shortening the games. Adrian Peterson, 34 carries, 211 yards. Phenomenal afternoon.
After review, there is no conclusive video evidence that the ball was tipped. Therefore, the play stands.
I tell you what.
Except that it changed directions.
Well, it got out of spiral. And having thrown a lot of balls, it got out of spiral. I would like that excuse that somebody tipped it.
You're too much.
I tell you what. First and 10 now for Oregon. They're in striking distance.
And still have a timeout.
That means they can throw the ball over the middle of the field. Fake to Stewart. To the end zone! Touchdown, Oregon! Brian Paysinger from Dennis Dixon!
The whole stadium is rocking.
First career touchdown for Brian Paysinger, the junior from Long Beach, California, Wilson High School. And this is the extra point by Martinez. Got it.
But there's still 46 seconds for the Sooners. Did they score too quickly? This play is set up, Dan, by the offensive line. They did a great job of giving him protection. Then look at the bottom. Number 19, Paysinger, does a little step dance, goes by Harris. And number 5, Harris, who has 2 interceptions. If you're even, he's leaving. Just gave him the stutter step. He bit on it. Harris, just a sophomore. Boy, what a nice throw, too. He waited for the fake, the stop and go. Saw him clear. Once he got the separation, laid the ball in perfectly to Paysinger.
And remember, it was Paysinger who illegally touched the onside kick. At least in our eyes, ball was given to Oregon with the recovery by Patrick Chung. Quick strike offense. 2 touchdowns in 22 seconds.
But hold on, there's still 46 seconds left, and look who's back to return his kick.
The Sooners have no timeouts.
Adrian Peterson.
Now, do you squib it or do you kick it deep?
I wouldn't kick it deep and give Peterson a chance to return it.
The other guy's a pretty good returner, too. Reggie Smith is back along with Peterson.
Just kick it to one of the up men. There it is.
This is Reggie Smith. He's got a big hole. 40. Reggie Smith ducked. Territory down the sidelines, knocked out of bounds.
Clock stops with 31 seconds left.
But once the referee signals ready to play, the clock will roll. Garrett Hartley's career long is 52 yards. Kicked that one last year against Texas, but he's in field goal range now.
Tried to keep it away from the receivers. They wanted the up men here to take it, but they left it on the ground. This is a great return. Look at the patience waiting for blocks to set. Cuts back inside. Peterson gets a block. All the way down deep. Now the offense will come up. No huddle. Clock's rolling again down to 25.
54 in motion. Peterson gets it right side. He's tackled at the line of scrimmage.
No timeouts left. Down to 12.
Thompson has got to kill the clock with a spike here. And he does, with 2 seconds going. 44 yards away for Garrett Hartley. For the win. Blocked! Blocked by Oregon! for the first time in seven tries on a blocked field goal.
Dan, when you're at the limits of your distance, you get into it, the kick's a little bit lower. They put the center rush on, they came up big for the block.
Jack!
Coach!
Yeah.
Describe to me the last 30 seconds of this game.
I'm not sure I really can, Jack. Our kids just wouldn't say die. Our defense did a great job. Our offense turned the ball over way too much, but they came through big time when we needed it. Our defense and our special teams with that block, that's a lot of fun. It'll be a lot of fun, Gene.
What did you tell the special teams on that last kick?
On the kickoff? Well, it was a squib middle, which was designed to screw up their timing. We did a very poor job of coverage, gave them a chance. It shouldn't have come down to that, but, now I'll take it. It's okay.
Seventh time's the charm.
Yeah, that's what I said. So I use that in my pregame speech, you know that?
Come on, baby! Guys!
Thanks, Jack. Bellotti now is 25-1 here at Autzen Stadium against non-conference teams. Sooners led it 33-20 with 3:12 to go. 3 minutes and 10 seconds later, Garrett Hartley's field goal try is stuffed in the middle of the defensive line by middle linebacker Blair Phillips.
The longer the kick, the lower the line, and allowed them to get up and block that kick. Terrific football game.